and no negative health effects have been found. This weekend, individuals concerned about the health effects of the weather-altering chemicals being sprayed are attending screenings of documentaries, participating in educational marches, and hosting lectures across the globe. The Austin, Texas event takes place tomorrow at noon at the Texas State Capitol. Visit gmacag.com to find a march in your area. Well, this weekend is full of Central Texas Liberty action for both anarchists and politicos. Alliance of Austin Agorists will hold their 9th networking party this Friday evening from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. at Brave New Books. Don't miss the opportunity to speak with four of Austin's finest crypto geniuses. Michael Goldstein, Justice Ranveer, Daniel Krawitz, and Jonathan Rumyan will each give a talk on what crypto anarchy and agorism means to them and why it matters. Be sure to enjoy the farmers market, free beer, and live music. Then on Monday, Texans for Accountable Government will be hosting a city council candidate forum and meet and greet. Austinites will have a chance to get FaceTime with candidates running in their district, as well as to get answers to the tough questions. The event will be held at Sherlock's Baker Street Pub on Research Boulevard from 6 to 9 p.m. More information at tagtexas.org. Today's edition of the Liberty Beat, brought to you by Brave New Books, your source for One World Way, Tangy Tangerine, and clearly filtered fluoride filters. Located in Austin, Texas, 1904 Guadalupe Street, or online at bravenewbookstore.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, September 26, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting.
Saying that he has no idea what to make of the mixed signals, area man Pete Summers told reporters today he keeps getting ambiguous text messages from local woman Haley Mueller, claiming that she's not at all interested in him.
One minute she's like, I don't want to go out with you. And then she'll mention how she has to go hang out with her boyfriend. What am I supposed to do with that?
Summers, who first met Mueller at a friend's party last month, informed reporters that the 27-year-old's increasingly perplexing text messages have left him unable to ascertain whether or not she would want to date him. He also noted that Mueller's behavior at social gatherings was equally vague.
Last weekend, we were at a party, and every time I would go up to her, she just said, "Leave me alone." Then I text her the next day, and she totally doesn't even respond. I mean, she just needs to make up her mind and tell me what she wants. She hasn't answered my last 3 phone calls, so maybe I should go over there and make sure everything's okay.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial toll free
and bring up anything that you would like here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. And with you in the studio tonight is Ian,
Ellen,
and Daryl.
And don't forget, you can join us online at freetalklive.com and get interactive there. You can actually create the content that you see on the front page of the site, the various news items that you'll see there, also YouTube videos, sometimes blog posts, whatever it is you want to submit. It doesn't have to be news-related. It could just be fun, something you really enjoyed. You put it up there on the website, and then other listeners can vote it up or down. You get to vote on things there as well. Just go and get interactive at freetalklive.com. Coming up, the FBI is upset. They're very angry about, apparently, Apple and Google. There's been news recently. I had it in my show prep a few nights ago, but we never got to it, like many things on the show. But the news was that Apple and Google had come up with encryption for their new operating systems on their phones, encryption that purportedly would prevent Apple and Google from being able to unlock your phone for the police.
Oh, and how upsetting.
The FBI is very upset about that. We'll get into that story. Your calls certainly are welcome, plus some ridiculous fines for both taking pictures in national forests, apparently, and for not recycling your food garbage.
The national forest thing definitely intrigues me, mm-hmm, because the fine is cheaper than what it would cost to get the permit to avoid the fine.
Are you? Wow. They right. set that up very poorly.
So we can talk about all that and more. Your calls are certainly welcome. Our toll-free number again is 855-450-FREE. We also have Skype, and our Skype username is lrn.fm. Plus, coming up, we'll talk about revenge porn. Apparently, that law is being challenged at a state-level law, right?
Yes, it's being challenged in Arizona.
Well, so we'll find out more about that here, and we'll tell you what revenge porn is in case you haven't heard about that. But first, let's go to the phones and the fun. Billy is in Asheville, North Carolina. Billy, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, it's me, Billy, again.
Well, hi, Billy. I don't remember you the first time, but welcome. Welcome back.
I called up last weekend about biomass energy.
Okay. I still don't recall, but I don't remember what I talked about two nights ago. So go ahead with your thoughts.
Is this like the people who would be on Sunday night, right?
You're talking about, you're talking about there on WWNC in North Carolina. It's a iHeartMedia station that carries our show live on, I think, on Sunday nights. Yes, that's correct. This is Free Talk Live.
So what I want to say is I wrote a letter to the Air Mission Agency in for North Carolina about about taking landfills into biomass by putting a biomass plant in each landfill. Since biomass is trash and energy. But I got a letter back today, and they basically just said that they already have it with methane or something, that some type of gas that comes from the ground from the trash. So,
methane sounds right.
Yeah, that's right. So what you're saying is, so biomass is where you take biological product, trash, garbage, things
trash.
Like that, and you turn it into energy. Is that the idea?
Yeah, but supposedly they already have methane, but I just wanted to give an update.
Hey, there you go. Thanks for the call tonight, Billy. I appreciate hearing from you. That's something I don't really know a whole lot about. I imagine that the story from Seattle may be related, where they're now fining people who throw away too much food. So we can get into that here in a little bit. Anybody a fan of the whole biomass?
I just don't know how they'd make it profitable. Like, how are you? It's just trash sitting there, and then somebody has to make this huge investment to go in and build this facility and hire all these workers. And how are they getting paid? Are they selling the biomass fuel?
That they're probably getting paid by some government agency somewhere.
Right. So it'd be a net loss.
Right, but it's one of those things that, you know, it's a make-work program. So we're giving people jobs, and it makes people feel good.
But that doesn't mean that this or some other similar idea wouldn't be profitable in a free marketplace where you actually had open competition, where, you know, if they could figure out a way to make that make money, then they'd be paying people for their trash. They'd pay you to pick up your garbage if they could make that profitable.
Right, and the thing is that somebody has to make that investment initially, though. And nobody's really going to do that because you can't turn a profit on something like trash right now. And it definitely should be done. Like, I think it would be, I think everybody would benefit from that. Not just, you know, a few people, but there would be more land open. There would be less pollution. And, like, I hope that somebody does it someday, but
right now it's not profitable, but maybe, you know,
in the future when inflation has gone up like 10,000%.
Well, right now governments in most places are in charge of trash collection and landfills and things like that. Actually, around here in Keene, New Hampshire, the government doesn't collect the trash, but they do run the town dump, the town landfill. So ultimately, governments are all over the place.
So they won't do the work, but they'll just provide the place for you to dump your stuff?
They won't do the... Oh, you mean the work of picking it up?
Yes.
Good. I don't want them to do the work of picking it up because I can choose from different companies who will do the pickups. Or I can just take it out to the dump myself. If I don't want to pay someone to pick it up, I can just load it up in the back of a truck and take it out there and take care of it myself.
Right, but that's one of those things to where you have to sort of... do the calculations yourself, figure out if it's more profitable for you to do the labor, because what's your time worth? How long does it take you to drive out to the dump?
And that's not the only
factor. Do you have a personal check on you, because they don't take cash here?
Right, or credit cards. And also, when you go out to the dump here, sometimes there's a line. So even if it doesn't take you very long to get there... you never know. Yeah, you never know how many people are going to be sitting in that line waiting to get into the dump.
Right.
Chess game at the dump drive-through.
And then do you have things that need to go to different areas? Because household trash goes to one place, electronics go somewhere else, metal goes somewhere, wood goes somewhere.
I'd rather pay the professionals to handle it, and I think I pay all of $25 a month for that. You know, somebody comes and picks it up once a week, just like it was in Florida. Although I don't remember... I know that in Florida, when I lived in Florida, where the government had some contractor doing it for everybody, I think they were charging a little bit less total than what I pay here.
Anyway, it's better to have somebody do it for you. I mean, that's why they say throw things away. You literally push it away from you so you don't have to think about it anymore.
But there's an interesting episode of Penn and Teller's BS, which is a great Showtime
program. I love that show.
Yeah, it was awesome. They did 8 seasons of it, and almost every episode was just fantastic. Some were better than others, but most of them were pretty great, and all of them are worth watching at least once. But one of them was focusing on recycling and
That's
landfills.
My favorite episode, because
that was a life-changing episode for me.
Well, they just show how ludicrous the whole thing is.
Are you talking about recycling glass and plastic?
They hit all of the recycling, and they right. do point out that I think it's aluminum and... Was glass one of the other ones? There was aluminum and something else that's actually worth recycling?
I think
copper
glass.
Wire, maybe?
Well, yeah, maybe copper would be as well. But they point out that like paper and plastic and stuff like this is not worth recycling at all. In fact, it's it's a negative effect. In fact, the bleaching process of recycling paper is actually more polluting than making new paper from trees and things like that. They kind of go into some really interesting, eye-opening points about why recycling is basically BS.
My favorite part of that episode, though, is where they go and they ask the people, okay, so right now you're separating paper, plastic, and glass. We've got a few more cans for you.
Yeah.
Let's see what you think. And it wound up to where they had 8 cans, and one of the things was paper products that had touched food, paper that had not touched food, soiled papers, so diapers, etc. And it was just absolutely ridiculous. And some of the people, it'll probably take me a little while to get used to it, but I'm okay with this.
Yeah, that was pretty ridiculous. It was kind of like a hidden camera thing where they went up to some homeowner's house and, you know, when he was taking the garbage out and sort of introduced him to the new system where they kept bringing out bin after bin after bin with different labels on it.
You want to recycle? Ha, you're on candid camera.
Just to see how far they could push it with this guy. How many bins could they bring out before the guy finally got fed up? And I don't think he got fed up. He just was, you know, people feel like it's their duty and that they're doing right. something for the earth when in point of fact... They pointed out that the EPA back in the 80s or whatever essentially came up with this idea, and then it's almost completely bunk on a lot of the things that we commonly recycle. So I gave up after that. More coming up here. This is Free Talk Live. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online, and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Allison Fry and Peter Hartman are a long-term couple. They've been trying out an open relationship that frees them to emotionally burden and exhaust other people.
We're both grown-ups. We both trust each other. It just seemed like the right time to open ourselves up to meeting other people and barraging them with our crippling emotional neediness.
Yeah, I mean, don't get me wrong. I still want to vent to Allison about all the anxieties I have at the office until she wishes I would just shut the f*** up. But sometimes You just get the urge to sap the life out of a different woman for a change.
The flexible arrangement has allowed Fran Hartman to participate in a variety of tiresome and psychologically draining one-off encounters with partners ranging from close acquaintances to total strangers.
Of course, there was a time when I couldn't imagine saddling anyone but Peter with my extensive emotional baggage and trust issues, but now that we've tried it...
The best part is, when we're back together, all we really want to do is drain the living shit out of each other.
This is the Onion News Network.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Ladies, with a U.S. divorce rate near 30% in this job market, looks matter. Breast enhancement or reduction, a tummy tuck, or a little lipo can work wonders on you and your confidence. With hospital rates at fractions of U.S. prices, and thanks to the recent Thai coup, unheard of low airfare and jaw-dropping deals on luxury hotel rooms. Provide a little info. Get a quote. Hit us up at AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free here. Bring up whatever you'd like. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in the studio tonight, Ian here.
Ellen.
Ellen with her mouth full. Busted.
You caught me eating a bagel.
I really didn't mean to, but yeah, she's here and she's back. We missed
usually
you last
week. Do the introductions two bits in a row.
Well, there's no rule. There's no hard and firm rule about that. In fact, the consultant says we should be saying our names more often. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We also have Skype. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. And what was your name across the table there?
Daryl.
All right, Daryl Perry from fpp.cc. Go and check more of him out there. He does his own radio show, Peace, Love, Liberty Radio, and a daily 7-day-per-week newscast. What is that?
236 consecutive days have been doing the FPP radio news.
Congratulations.
It's amazing.
5-minute daily newscast that you can find at fppradio.com. There's also, I believe, 4 different online radio networks that run the newscast in some sort of rotating top of the hour news circulation.
Including LRN.FM,
yes.
As a matter of fact, which you have done a fine job, by the way, as your assistant program director role here at LRN.FM, my little internet network. You have secured a Roku distribution,
yes,
for LRN.FM. Now, Ellen, are you familiar with the Roku?
I am, actually.
Have you used one?
I use it occasionally.
Is it yours?
It's not mine. I don't own it, but I'm familiar with it, and I've pushed a few buttons within the Roku system.
I have never used a Roku, but I'm tempted to buy one now because I've heard so much about it, and they're cheap. What, $50, $60?
Somewhere
like that?
In like the 60 to 80 range, depending
80.
On
yeah, there's different
which
models,
model
right?
You get, where you buy from, etc.
Now, as I understand it, this Roku is like the number one box, like receiving box thing that people have as far as its category.
Sounds right.
Basically, it's a box you plug into your TV set that it hooks up wirelessly to the internet and or to your router or whatever, your house or your office or wherever. And then it can receive television signals, you know, different online streaming video, for instance, but also radio signals as well, stream online audio. And I guess anybody who has a Roku can put in channels into the system.
Yes.
And you did that, Daryl. And now apparently, I'm shocked, it's only been there for about a week.
About a week with very little promotion.
I didn't mention it online anywhere until today.
Wow.
I mentioned it twice the day that it went live.
Right. You mentioned it
1 week ago.
You mentioned it on the AMP group, the Free Talk Live AMP group, which only has like 200 some people in it.
So what if I wanted to go home tonight and find this on Roku? How would I go about finding it?
Just search for LRN or Liberty Radio Network.
Woo.
Or just searching for Liberty Works or,
right,
like you said, LRN. Or just go to lrn.roku.com. Excuse me, not that. Go to roku.lrn.fm, and that'll take you straight to their page on their website, which proves that we're actually there. It's really amazing. And so far, we've had 21 ratings on there, which, again,
21 people have rated the channel. And 1,100 people, over 1,100 people, have added it to their device.
Which I'm amazed by, which, you know, haven't done.
That's great.
We haven't done any promotion, so I presume that's just people with Rokus. I think there's several million of them out there.
Yeah.
Just people looking for new content, and LRN's new there. So if you got a Roku, check us out there, because you can listen live via that. Very cool stuff. Our toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. Since we're talking about garbage, we actually had somebody call in just by chance at the beginning of the show to talk about this biomass idea, turning biological waste into fuel. The sort of the consensus among the panel here was that doesn't really seem like it would be profitable, but
in,
you know,
the current
right now
setting of things,
maybe in the future when the government isn't handling garbage disposal,
maybe
then
in the future when we can just split molecules without putting very much energy into it.
Great point. Yeah, so who knows what's going to change, because when one discovery happens, it can totally change a game. So, for instance, a great example of this is oil, crude oil, right? This stuff was a pollutant up until the point when someone figured out that you could burn it and turn it into energy, basically. It was a farmland pollutant, and it was an annoyance. So these farmers were upset when they had oil on their property coming up out of the ground.
Can you imagine living in that time period? Like, I got this terrible oil spill.
It was a problem. But then,
don't know what to do with it.
The farmers that kept the land that had the oil on it probably became, you know, multimillionaires after it became valuable, after people figured out with their human ingenuity how to turn this annoyance into something that was incredibly valuable and still is today. So that there could, you know, we could just be waiting to see what sort of biomass advances happen that could totally change the game and turn things around to where you actually get paid for giving people garbage, which would be an amazing turnaround.
Yeah.
You know, I should patent this idea, because when I was in kindergarten, I drew a picture of a machine that took in trash and spat out like whatever predetermined object you chose.
Like a 3D printer.
Yeah. Well, kind of, except instead of having a plastic wire that you feed into the head, is just trash.
Well, the 3D printers are sort of the first step in the realm of going into kind of having these what's like Star Trek with the, what do they call them, the replicators?
Yeah,
there. Yeah.
I actually saw something a couple of days ago. They actually have a 3D pen now.
A 3D pen, as in you write with it?
You draw things. And it spits out the plastic, similar to a 3D printer.
Wow.
And you can, like, draw into the air, and then the plastic goes up, and you can make 3D objects with this handheld pen.
Wait, now the pen doesn't print, too, does it? It's, like, connected to a printer that does the printing?
No. You hold it in your hand, and you press a little button, and plastic comes out, and then you form things.
So, is it... It's not the size of a traditional pen, though, is it?
It's the size of a large Sharpie.
So then the things it prints out are very small. It must not have that much material in it.
Well, you keep feeding in plastic things. They showed somebody that had one of the objects that they have on their website is somebody that has made a replica of the Eiffel Tower that is like a foot and a half tall.
So you can literally sculpt in the air.
Yes.
That is amazing.
How does it defeat gravity? Wonderful. I don't understand.
The plastic hardens.
Yeah. Really? It's that fast? Wow.
Apparently.
Yeah. Incredible. All right. So let's go to the phones here. George is in California. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, George.
Hi. How are you guys out there?
Good. What's on your mind tonight?
I'm up in the Sierra Nevada mountains, and basically I know a little bit about alternate energy. My brother is one of the top 10 solar engineers in the state of California.
Okay.
And he has two solar companies down in Los Angeles. And basically, I was listening to the conversation. And I've been involved in solar energy for about 45 years myself, and was studying it when I was 14, and I'm 57 now.
Hmm.
And there's just so many wonderful programs and so many good things that are out there that are going on with alternate energy. It's almost like if you really thought about it, all the amount of time, the decades, that all of these different energies like geothermal energy and solar energy and biomass energy and all the ways of doing water heating or solar electric.
George, I want you to hold that thought. I want you to come up with, you said there's a lot that's exciting. I want you to pick the most exciting one and tell us about it in a moment. So hang on, we're going to bring it back on Free Talk Live.
The Genesis Communications Network is one of America's premier broadcasters of captivating talk radio. We thank you for listening. Now, just imagine, there are thousands of people who are just as passionate about radio as you are. But what you may not realize is how easy and affordable it is to advertise with us. Radio commercials for your business could be heard on hundreds of radio stations across the U.S. every day. We can help you by creating an effective radio advertising campaign for your company. From script writing to producing your commercial, just like the one you're listening to right now, no other network provides the level of customer service we do. When it comes to radio advertising, we are your one-stop shop. And no matter how big or small your business is, we can help. Email us at advertise@gcnlive.com and an experienced advertising executive will help you take the first step towards driving more customers to your business or website. Advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
The Shire Free Church offers a sanctuary to those seeking an escape from state churches.
The Shire Free Church is an interfaith, diverse group of people that may not share identical theological beliefs. As a member in or minister of the Shire Free Church, you are a sovereign individual and may be the faith of your choice.
We don't claim to have all of the answers.
We are open to all peaceful people.
We want to learn from each other.
What unifies the Shire Free Church and its diverse members is peace,
love, and liberty. There are many paths to God, one for every individual.
The Shire Free Church does not define a specific path beyond those parameters that must be your foundation.
Peace as your way,
love as your guide,
and liberty as your light.
Learn more at church.shiresociety.com.
That's church.shiresociety.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls toll-free at 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. You can also join us via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Tonight in studio, Ian here.
Ellen.
And Daryl.
Join us, of course, online. Get involved on the website there. Totally free. We're going to go right back into your phone calls and thoughts. Then we'll tell you about the new law in Seattle, voted, I believe, unanimously by the Seattle City Council to punish people who throw out too much food. Whatever the amount, arbitrary amount selected by the government agents is too much. We'll tell you more about that here in a few moments. First, we go back to George. In California, but want to tell you about how to get a free pound of some of the best coffee out there from BuzzBox. All you have to do is pay the shipping cost. You get the pound for zero cost beyond that, and it's 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica, and is shade grown. Now, BuzzBox is great coffee. In fact, Mark, our normal weekday co-host, he says he drinks a pot of this stuff every single day. He's a huge fan of BuzzBox coffee. And they do something special, though. They let us, they've teamed up with us and Kiva to fund microloans to different people around the world to make their lives better, to, you know, improve their business, get some new equipment, or whatever it is they need to do to make a better life for themselves. The microloans from Kiva allow that to happen. And every 10 listeners that signs up for the program at coffee.freetalklive.com, we'll be able to fund a new microloan. And whenever one of the microloans is paid off, we'll take that money back in and then refund another. We'll fund another microloan after that. So go to coffee.freetalklive.com, get signed up there. You get the first pound free, just pay the shipping cost. And you can cancel your subscription at any time. But obviously BuzzBox is so, you know, they believe in their product so much, they think that you're going to love it and hopefully continue on. And if you do continue on, you can adjust the shipping frequency. You can adjust the amount of coffee that you get at that shipping frequency. It's very handy. So coffee.freetalklive.com. Again, that's coffee.freetalklive.com. George is with us. You said you spent the last few decades, several decades of your life doing research and you know, learning about and experiencing the alternative energy world. And there's a lot of different exciting stuff out there. You know, obviously things are getting better all the time. And I asked you to, you know, pick one. What's the most exciting alternative energy technology out there from your perspective, George?
I think basically you've got geothermal, which is like unlimited. And so because they can go down and drill these beautiful wells now in places like Brawley Field on Salton Sea in Southern California, places like Geyserville, a couple hours north of San Francisco, and then out of Lake Tahoe is another area. So basically you got like 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You could keep going probably for a while. These unbelievable areas where they can drill for geothermal energy, and they've got like multi-megawatt plants just kicking butt.
Wow! So the idea would be you drill down in these hot spots and then build a distribution.
It's already being done.
You build a distribution plant on top of it, and then send out power over power lines.
Yeah, that part of it.
You can also
it's been done for a long time. So this isn't new, by the way. Mm-hmm. This is old.
As far as I understand it,
what's on the grid?
As far as I understand, you can also do small-scale geothermal for just a household.
Oh, I know people. I was in New Zealand. I was staying at a guy's house. He had 12 bedrooms. He was a doctor. His doctor's office was on the property. His house was located on a cold creek with trout and a hot creek with geothermal. This place was so hot, it was at a place called Rotorua on the North Island of New Zealand, that he had steam coming out of his front yard. Is that nutty?
Wow.
It must be a little nerve-wracking to live in that house.
I know. And not that far away, we'll say maybe a mile, is a hospital. And the hospital, there's a big mound there that's steaming from the last time that it blew up. And this whole area, I think, Rotorua is nutty. There's certain places in the world.
Oh, my goodness.
Rotorua is like thermal to such a degree that they have a place where all the people live in a place where all the streams and all the little waterways in between are actually steaming.
See, I'm sorry. Like, that's just so ridiculous. And that brings to mind for me.
Ridiculous how? What do you mean?
This is real.
It's like people who live in New Orleans. Like, you know that it's going to flood or explode at some point.
That's not how people look at things when they live in, this location in the registry was considered the eighth wonder of the world. It was called the Vermilion Falls. And this is the little town below the Vermilion Falls. And Vermilion, I'm kind of familiar with colors, but I'm thinking that's kind of like a coralish color.
I think it's a deep red.
Vermilion?
Vermilion? Yes. I don't know.
So these cliffs, they were called the Vermilion Cliffs. And in the 1880s, people were all over the world would try and get there because it was considered the eighth wonder of the world. And it was these beautiful hot springs, and they were Vermilion Cliffs. And they went down these beautiful, like hundreds and hundreds of feet of these beautiful steaming area, kind of like you'd see over in Yellowstone, over there. Anyway, so what they did was they're just doing their little jungle thing out there in the 1880s, and tourists are coming in from all over the world to see the place, and the whole place blew up.
George, thanks for sharing your thoughts and the stories tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I haven't taken the time, like a lot of people who are really into the alternative energies, to do much, if any, research into them. But I love the ideas of, you know, getting energy from different sources. The one thing that concerns me, of course, is having the government pick a winner. Right, where the government says, well, this is the most important energy source, and then they take your money by the threat of force, and then they fund development and research into one of those areas or more, you know, whatever areas they think are important. And I think that skews the marketplace from what the people really want,
right?
What people really value.
If you think about it, people are always going to choose the more efficient option. And thermal, like geothermal energy, sounds very like superior in if you compare it to things like wind or solar, because those are ways of collecting energy so that you can produce heat. Well, maybe not those specifically, but like nuclear energy.
Well, solar,
energy,
you collect it into batteries.
Right. That would be like direct electron transfer, but something like nuclear energy, where you're just producing all this heat, that's just so that you can heat up the water so that you can turn the turbine so that you can produce energy, whereas this is just like the direct, you know, like it's just feeding directly up out of the ground. Like there's no additional process you have to add to it.
Yeah, I don't know. I tend to agree with Ian, you know, that government shouldn't be involved in any of the picking the winners and losers. And as long as that's happening, and we've seen programs in Arizona, for instance, where they opened up the HOV lanes to people that were in alternative fuel vehicles, whether or not they had extra people in their car or not, and they were giving all sorts of weird tax incentives to people for buying these vehicles, so people would go out and buy the vehicles for the purpose of being able to use the high occupancy lane by themselves.
Except not for long, because then everyone will own... Sorry, everyone will own an alternative energy car at that point.
Yeah,
and then
the
they'll all be competing for the lane. It'll
yeah,
even
but,
out eventually.
Yeah, that's just one of the things to where, you know, governments are directing people through different tax incentives.
Mm-hmm.
And then with electricity delivery, and of course it's opened up over the past, you know, couple of decades, but for the longest time, the vast majority of people in the U.S., only had one company that they could get electricity from.
Right. Still that way. It's still that way.
Well, kind of. You can choose who sends you the bill now. It's still being delivered by the same company, but on paper, it looks like it's coming from somewhere else.
You're talking about in New Hampshire. That may not be the case in other places. Like in New Hampshire, there's like the delivery and the supplier of power. And I think it's, I forget who, there's one of those things that you can pick now in New Hampshire.
Basically, you pick who sends you the bill, and you have that option in most of the country now.
Really? Okay. That's,
yes.
That's news to me. I thought it was a New Hampshire statute change that allowed that to happen. More coming up here in a moment. It's 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We'll talk about the Seattle ban coming up.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
A world without breast cancer is a world with more birthdays. And by signing up for the Making Strides Against Breast Cancer Walk, you will help us get there faster. Because you're helping the American Cancer Society make the greatest impact and save more lives in more communities through groundbreaking research and access to screenings for women who need them.
Walk in Making Strides Against Breast Cancer, because you can help us finish the fight. Sign up today at MakingStridesWalk.org.
Have you heard? Proactiv Plus is faster and better than ever. Stay tuned for a million bottle giveaway, and you'll also receive free shipping. Do you have troubled skin? Acne? Well, we have great news. With Proactiv Plus, your acne can heal, and you can help prevent new breakouts from happening. Don't miss this limited-time offer. Give us a call at 800-538-5252, because we're going to let a million people try Proactiv Plus risk-free. And get two free gifts and also receive free shipping when you call right now. You heard it. This offer won't last long. So call Proactiv Plus now and you'll receive a 60-day risk-free trial of Proactiv Plus, two free extras, and free shipping. Call 800-538-5252. This is our exclusive radio offer, never on TV. Get your risk-free 60-day trial of Proactiv Plus with free shipping. That's right, free shipping. Don't wait. Call 800-538-5252. That's 800-538-5252.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free here. Bring up whatever's on your mind. The toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us online. Just go to freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features that are waiting for you there. So a lot of excitement among some of our listeners tonight about alternative energy sources. And I like it. I'm fine with the idea of alternative energy. I'm not married to one form of energy or another. You know, obviously it makes sense to have efficient energy. The more efficient it is, I like that, because efficiency means you're getting more for your dollar, and you know, you're not wasting energy in the process of energy in the process of delivering the energy and that sort of thing. And our network today, the power grid as we know it, is a not very efficient setup. It's really not very great at all. Now, Daryl, you were talking about the deregulation that happened, and you said it happened at the national level, which is interesting. I didn't know that. I figured it was a New Hampshire thing, but I
thought it was at the national level, and I just pulled up a
you may
map
be right.
of states that have deregulated to some extent the utilities.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a fair number that have deregulated only electricity. Some have only deregulated gas. Some have given people a partial choice on gas. Some have done a partial choice on both electric and gas. And others have fully deregulated. And it looks as though there's probably 20 states that have not deregulated at all.
Oh, that's interesting. So it wasn't national.
I thought it was, okay. But apparently it was
state?
Not.
Okay, and also information, just to clarify the discussion we were having earlier, in New Hampshire at least, and again, your mileage may vary, it may be different where you live, but what has changed here about power delivery is that there's a big power company, the sort of the state-approved power company, PSNH as it's called, Power Supply of New Hampshire, I believe is what that stands for. They are still providing the delivery of the power, meaning that they own the lines and they operate and they repair, maintain the lines. But now you can pick from the supplier. So in New Hampshire, and I believe Maine as well.
New Hampshire and Maine, according to this map, and this map could be inaccurate, New Hampshire and Maine and Connecticut of New England states have deregulated only electricity.
Can you do me a favor and drop that map, that link, onto our Facebook, Google Plus,
absolutely,
and Twitter when you get a chance? Now, if you've not signed up for, or, you know, not following us on Facebook, Google Plus, and Twitter, please go to news.freetalklive.com. There's easy links to click into any one of those three there, whatever your preference happens to be, and then you can check that map and see if this applies to you. The reason why I even knew about this in the first place, because I started getting this deluge of email, or not email, but mail, like flyers from these companies saying, hey, now energy's been deregulated in New Hampshire. Now you can switch and save 10% on energy supply. So I switched. I mean, why the hell not, right? Like, okay, save 10, 15%. Okay, sure, we'll do that. And so there seem to be multiple companies now offering energy supply. The bill still comes from the power delivery company, PSNH, as it's called here. So they still bill, but they're billing for the supplier as well. So the bill's broken down into the cost that you pay for supply and the cost that you pay for delivery. So I think that's great news. You know, the more deregulation, the better. That means more choices for consumers, and ultimately I'd love to see more choice for the delivery of power as well. Right now there's still, at least here in New Hampshire, there's only one option for power delivery, at least if you're not going to somehow set up your own off the grid home, right? Like if you've got enough solar and wind, then maybe you could go off the grid, or I don't know if there's geothermal in New Hampshire, I'm not sure if that's available here. But if you have, you know, some of these alternatives, there is certainly the possibility that you can disconnect completely from the grid and or send or sell energy back to the grid, which, of course, would be an ideal situation. But I'd like to see more options as far as delivery, and nuclear power could be a possibility there. But nuclear power is so heavily regulated that you can't build a new nuclear facility anywhere in the United States. All the nuclear facilities. Now, there's a lot of there's a lot of complaints and concerns about nuclear power, but I think a lot of those concerns and complaints are based on the fact that this is old tech. The U.S. government, as I understand it, won't allow new technology to be developed in the realm of nuclear power.
Right. I'm sure the restrictions are just, you know,
ridiculous.
Strangling the technology.
Well, they're not outside of the U.S. There's development going on. I remember seeing some sort of online picture of a Honda nuclear generator that was like, you know, something you could have on this in your side yard and have it power an entire neighborhood or something like that.
Well, see, just the sound of that makes me nervous. But then again, that's why, I feel like there's a lot of people that are just as nervous about something like that. You know, like when I was in high school and we were learning about this, most people, when we took the survey, said, oh, I think nuclear energy sounds like a great option, but I wouldn't be comfortable with living within like 5 miles of one. But really, you should be more concerned about living near like coal-powered plants, because those give off much more pollution.
Well, most people don't want to live near those. No. People don't want to live near the big wind turbines. You know, people
because they make noise.
Right. People want all of these alternatives. But at the same time, it's always the not in my backyard sort of thing, to where nobody wants it near them, but they want to be able to benefit from them.
Well, so what we heard about not too long ago on the show, somebody had called in about, I believe it was thorium, which is some sort of a more safe nuclear option for power generation, and that's about as much as I can recall to explain to you how why.
There was some automobile that was made that was supposed to have been able to run off of thorium, and it was supposed to get, like, you know, run for 100 years on 8 ounces or something
like that.
Right.
Yeah.
I read about that a few years ago, but the thing is that thorium is such a rare metal that it would be extremely expensive to have something like that.
I don't know. Let's see if we can learn more about that here in a little bit.
The thing is that, but the thorium, The molecules that they use are built in a specific way so that when they absorb energy, they're basically shaped like a swing set. You know, like they have both the molecular arms facing the same way. And when they release energy, they switch into the opposite position. So when they absorb energy, they just go back again.
You are clearly somebody who's cut out for chemical engineering, which is what you're going to be studying, as I understand it, right? Isn't that something you're interested in doing?
Yeah, eventually, yes.
So let's go to Daryl in Austin, Texas. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Daryl.
Yes, like I was telling your call screener, I'm a journeyman ship and boat electrician, 20 years in the Navy. And one thing is I hear these talking heads talk about alternative energy, and most of them don't really know what they're talking about. Still the most efficient way to generate electricity is usually with a gas turbine. And the way some of these gas turbines work for these power plants, because one of my friends was getting a job at one, is they'll be running these two huge gas turbines, which are pretty much jet engines. And then they'll use waste heat off of them when they're running two at a time to run another boiler to actually run a third plant off that waste heat to use that energy to create even more electricity. And so normally they'll have like three of these gas turbines in a plant plus the waste boiler system to create electricity, and that is very efficient. Now, I'm all for alternative energy, but some places like, you know, Texas in the summer is a great place for solar power, but not so much Alaska in the winter.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, New Hampshire probably not the best place for solar either if there's a lot of cloud cover. Then, especially if there's not a lot of daylight either, that could be a problem. But yeah, I mean, different solutions for different parts of the planet, that makes sense. Anything else you want to share, Daryl?
Yeah, also the wind power. There was a case in Iowa, and right on, I think it was at I-80, but outside of Des Moines, Iowa, going towards Omaha. There's like a school there off the highway that has a wind turbine generator. And when they built the thing, they had to talk about government getting in the way. They had to go to the state legislature to change the law so they could have a generator for that school.
It's ridiculous. Thanks for the call tonight, man. I do appreciate hearing from you. It's a story from Forbes.com. The thing about thorium, why the better nuclear fuel may not get a chance. And we can talk more about, you know, what it is that that thorium is allegedly so great for. Says here, the Fukushima disaster reminded us all of the dangers inherent in uranium-fueled nuclear reactors. Fresh news this month about TEPCO's continued struggle to contain and cool the fuel rods highlights just how energetic uranium fission reactions are and how challenging to control. Of course, that level of energy is exactly why we use nuclear energy. It's incredibly efficient as a source of power, and it creates very few emissions and carries a laudable safety record to boot. This conversation, nuclear good but uranium dangerous, regularly leads to a very good question. What about thorium? It sits two spots left of uranium on the periodic table with the same row in the same row or series. Elements in the same series share characteristics with uranium and thorium. The key similarity is that both can absorb neutrons and transmute into fissile elements. That means thorium could be used to fuel nuclear reactors just like uranium. And as proponents of the underdog fuel will happily tell you, Thorium is more abundant in nature than uranium and is not fissile on its own, which means reactions can be stopped when necessary. More coming up.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
Free speech is protected on the internet, right? Not always. Government agencies try to limit free speech and commerce on the net. Luckily, when they do, the Institute for Justice is there to defend your First Amendment right to free speech. IJ helped set the first federal precedent for internet free speech in 1999, and ever since has worked to prevent unconstitutional roadblocks in cyberspace. Visit our website today at ij.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, September 26th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.55 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,220 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $402. Antiwar.com reports the Fatah-Hamas negotiation in Cairo has reached an agreement which will see their national unity government, agreed to back in May, take over control of the Gaza Strip. That ends the long-standing dispute over who would pay government employees in the Strip who had previously been paid by the Hamas government. Officials say they will now be paid by the unity government and will answer to them. In theory, the agreement is effective immediately, though in practice, implementation may take some time. The main goal of the deal is to get border crossings opened for reconstruction material. The unity government, being in control, will also put considerable pressure on Israel to allow that construction material to be sent in faster without the excuse of acrimony towards Hamas. Israel has opposed the unity government, saying they don't want to deal with any faction which Hamas is even peripherally a part of.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports Eric Holder said on Thursday he would step down as U.S. Attorney General, setting up a potentially bruising Senate fight to confirm a successor who can tackle a long list of pending challenges at the Justice Department. Holder will remain in office until a successor is nominated and confirmed. His nearly six-year term made him one of the nation's longest-serving attorneys general. The next attorney general will face many challenges, including managing counterterror initiatives aimed at Islamic State militants, balancing privacy rights against government surveillance efforts, and deciding whether to continue attempts to prosecute former spy agency contractor Edward Snowden, now living in Russia, for revealing surveillance secrets.
Holder's successor will also oversee a series of cases against banks and individuals over manipulation of foreign exchange rates. Holder's department could set off a tense confirmation fight with Republicans in a lame duck U.S. Senate session scheduled after the November 4th midterm election, although the chamber's majority Democrats can invoke rules making it easier to get around Republican efforts to block the confirmation. Republicans hope to gain a Senate majority in the elections, making it likely Obama will send up a nomination before a new Congress convenes in January. Despite a drumbeat of Republican criticism since becoming Attorney General in 2009, Holder is one of the last three original members of Obama's cabinet, along with Education Secretary Arne Duncan and Agriculture Secretary Tom Vilsack. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. Antiwar.com reports a handful of Republican members of the House Foreign Affairs Committee have gone off to Turkey to create their own historic coalition of rebel factions, which pledge to attack both the Islamic State and Syria's Assad government. Led by Representatives Adam Kinzinger and George Holding, the coalition was said to include more than 20 Syrian rebel commanders, though it appears to be little more than the nominal leadership of the Free Syrian Army and the minuscule Syriac Military Council. The groups called on the U.S. to expand their airstrikes beyond the Islamic State and al-Qaeda and against Assad's military as well. The Syriac Military Council, which is a militia affiliated with Syria's Christian minority, has fought a handful of battles against the Islamic State and al-Qaeda's Jabhat al-Nusra, mostly unsuccessfully. The new coalition doesn't appear to have much momentum behind it, nor is it clear if the assorted members have been part of the vetted moderate rebel factions that the U.S. intends to arm. It is primarily noteworthy in that it appears to have been created by congressmen independent of the administration's own efforts at coalition building. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
It's the Onion Radio News. A spokeswoman gives birth to a spokeschild. This is Doyle Redland reporting. Tacoma spokeswoman Tammy Barker became the proud mother of a bouncing baby spokeschild last night. According to spokespeople, Barker, a spokeswoman for a Tacoma-based pharmaceutical firm, the birthing process was a major success. Peter Wahlberg, spokesman for Tammy's husband Phil, had this to say.
At 9:17 p.m. last night, an 8.5-month-old spokesfetus was delivered alive and through the miracle of birth became a 7-pound, 6-ounce spokeschild. Spokesfather and spokesmother are doing fine.
Spokeswoman Barker is expected to be released from St. Robert's Hospital tomorrow. The spokeschild will remain in the hospital's media care unit for several weeks of training. Doyle Redland for The Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
This is The Onion News Network.
Talk Live. You can bring up whatever you'd like. Just dial in toll free here at 855-450-FREE with you in the studio. It's Ian here.
Ellen.
And Daryl.
Don't forget you can join us via Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. As usual, we bring things to the table to discuss with you about whatever, you know, you want to talk about. But we also have things that we find interesting, although we haven't gotten to that yet because we opened up with a call who was discussing alternative energy, and that sort of led into a larger conversation, and now we're talking about nuclear power, and there's a story over at Forbes about thorium, and somebody had called in previously, I think, about thorium here on Free Talk Live, suggesting that it was actually a much safer option than uranium as far as creating nuclear power is concerned, and Forbes seems to be acknowledging that, but they say in their article here that it may not get a chance, and we'll find out why here in moments. Let's go first to Joe, listening in St. George, Utah, to KZNU. Hello, Joe.
Hey, guys. How are you?
Good. What's on your mind?
Well, I just wanted to not stand on my soapbox too much, but you guys kind of hit the nail on the head with before that people are, they're so worried about, you hear the term renewable energy so much, and alternative energy kind of correlates with that. I'm an engineer in the oil and gas industry, and we make things called expanders. And we've actually developed a new type of expander that can recover a lot of waste energy in the oil and gas industry. And that's where I think people are really missing the point. The people are trying to look for this unobtainium type of energy source and something that's renewable and that can power cities all over the world with very little risk. And it's, the problem is that it doesn't leave a lot of energy and resources to develop the technologies that we currently have. Everybody's looking for the new source instead of developing those ideas and mechanisms that we currently have to make them better. I'm all for nuclear energy, and you guys are right. The regulations are absurd about preventing nuclear energy. And actually, coal power plants produce more radiation than nuclear energies ever do that escape the actual power plant. So it's actually ridiculous.
So here's my thoughts.
You guys.
Here's my thoughts real quick. Why not have something to where people are being encouraged to have several different types of energy to complement one another instead of competing with one another? For instance, there's, you know, every building has at least four corners. So on government buildings especially, put up some sort of small wind turbine on every corner. There's a lot of roof space. You could very easily put some solar panels on top. Then you're having solar and wind complement one another. And I'm not saying I'm not saying get rid of the power lines running into, but have these other forms to complement that as well. And then things aren't competing against one another, but making everything better.
Oh, no, absolutely. I mean, I don't know if you recall, 10 years ago, solar was coming out, and it was looked at and mocked at that it was just too expensive, dollar per kilowatt. You couldn't produce solar panels that would justify the economics. But look at what progression has done. You can get about a dollar a watt right now, and sometimes even cheaper.
Wow.
And for your own private home, you can power your entire house for that.
Yeah, there's no doubt. Well, it's okay. So maybe I'm confused about what you were saying earlier. It sounded like you were bemoaning that there's research going on in these other areas, but you know, it's not like we want to have the government pick a winner and fund that one area to put more research into. We want the market to decide these things. We want people who are interested in solar to research solar. And
yeah, and that would make more sense, especially depending on what area you're in. You might have a better chance at one type of energy than another.
Mm-hmm.
Right, Arizona, Nevada, you're going to have more sun hours than over back east, for instance, or on the upper northwest coast. It's the problem with starting up and searching for something that's easy instead of developing what we have. There are technologies out there that people just need to put energy or resources in to develop instead of looking for this renewable alternative energy that solves all of our problems.
Yeah, and they really should, but how are you going to get people to, you know, be motivated to
do that? You can't get people on the same page. It's just not going to be possible. I mean, it doesn't hurt to try to persuade folks, like, hey, I think you should be researching this technology, but ultimately people are going to pick what they pick. People are going to throw money at what they throw it at, and some people are going to lose as a result of that, and that's okay.
Right, and it's like a rare genius that comes up with this great invention and doesn't sell out before he ever, you know, achieves upgrading it 10 times.
But, I mean, you know, there are people who are putting research into, like you said, you're doing engineering work on gas and oil, right? So you're doing that work.
Oh, absolutely. The problem, for instance, we're actually a startup company. We've been around for 6 years so far, and we are breaking through into the market. The biggest problem that we've had is the uneducated people that are actually making the decisions, not understanding
Just to clarify, the uneducated people are in what positions? Are they in companies making decisions or government? Who are we talking about?
The higher ups, investor groups. It's very expensive for a startup company right now.
To break into a market, it takes a lot of capital and a lot of funding.
Sure.
And it's just difficult when people that do have that power that don't understand things about energy and what a renewable energy source kind of is, but what alternative energy sources really lie on, where we need to develop the technology that we have now. They're the ones making the decisions, and it's really difficult, especially for the startup businesses that do have these ideas that are developing these different types of ways to make current energy sources more efficient. Everybody's looking for the bandwagon, new fad, the new energy source or the new idea instead of just developing what we currently have.
I get your point, Joe. Thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you, and thanks for the expertise and experience.
But let me just add that if it wasn't for, you know, new types of energy sources coming about, people would still be hunting wells to get the blubber to light their candles at night.
Right. We'd all be reliving Moby Dick every day of our lives. But but he did have a good point. I'm sorry. I was trying to get to that.
No,
I think I almost interrupted Daryl, but I stopped.
No, go ahead. Okay. I made my point.
No, but he's right. A lot of people would prefer to be the one to find something new and like shiny and look at this instead of, you know, taking the more modest route, but actually being more productive, you know, if you were to develop something that already exists instead of like going for something totally different.
Well, I can understand his frustration. Obviously, that's his business, right?
Right.
So,
right.
Of course, he wants the venture capitalists and the investors out there to understand why what he's doing is valuable and why he believes that there's more potential in developing the existing sources rather than trying to find some new magical thing on the horizon.
I think there's potential in all of it.
Right. And that's why a lot of investors will put their money in different areas, right? Because they know that one will not necessarily work out, but they might want to be in the one that is working out, and they don't know which one's going to work out because, as he pointed out, the investor is not the expert. They, you know, they don't know really anything about energy development, but they, you know, if you can come up with a good pitch, then maybe they'll give you some money.
If you can make it seem like it's not as risky as it actually is, because I'm sure it's incredibly risky.
Well, yeah, trying to find something that's new sounds more risky than what he's talking about, which is funding development of existing technologies. So, speaking of that, let's get back to the story from Forbes about thorium. Now, this story is a couple years old at this point, but since we were talking about the issue, they point out here that, Ellen, you had said that thorium isn't very available, but apparently you did some research. You found out it's actually four times more available than...
It's four times more plentiful. It's just that there's no demand for it right now,
than
so it's
uranium.
Not being... provided.
Four
yes.
times more than uranium.
Yes.
More of it's in the ground than there is uranium. That doesn't necessarily mean that more of it has been extracted from the ground.
Fair enough. Right. But if they were going to be utilizing it,
it's just in the Earth's crust. It's not readily there.
We'll get into a little bit more about this here, because Forbes magazine says that thorium is allegedly a better nuclear fuel, but it might not get a chance. We'll find out why here in a little bit. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Plus, a man has hung himself to get out of the horror of the persecution by his local government, who attempted to steal his property and actually
did steal his property.
We'll come back with more, but they were then going to steal his home from him as well. More on the way here. This is Free Talk Live. You can take control.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything. Our toll-free number is 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features we share with you. We're talking about alternative energy sources, and you can share your thoughts with us on whatever aspect of that or something completely different. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Something else that's different is Bitcoin, different from all other currencies you've probably ever experienced in your life. Bitcoin's a decentralized currency. It's not created by any bank or any government, and it puts the power of money into your hands, which is a huge change for money, because normally it's the government and the banks that have been in control of money, and that's changed now. So if you've been into the Bitcoin world, then maybe you want to get a little bit more Bitcoin into your hands. Well, there's usually have to work for it, and in this case, you're going to have to work for it over at BitcoinBountyHunter.com. There are bounties available for you to collect right now, but you got to do the investigating that is necessary to collect the bounty. So you can put your own bounty or add to the ones that are already there. These cases are not going to be solved by the authorities. It's going to be done by someone like you, somebody who's got the skills and people that profit from their work and skills. So go check out BitcoinBountyHunter.com. One of the bounties there is worth 38 Bitcoins. That's a lot of money. So go to BitcoinBountyHunter.com. We were talking about thorium, and the larger conversation was about alternative energies, which led to a conversation about nuclear reaction or reactors, etc., and a discussion about thorium, because someone had called in previously, not tonight, but a different night, told us about thorium, and I, of course, I'm no expert at all on these things, so I just vaguely recalled that it was better than uranium. That's about all I knew about it. And Forbes has a more detailed piece here about that. So I'm going to continue. So the story here over at Forbes says that actually thorium is more available in the Earth's crust than uranium. And there's this conversation that nuclear is good, but uranium is dangerous, which leads to the question, well, what about thorium? Why are people using uranium rather than this allegedly safer, what they say is not fissile on its own, which means that reactions can be stopped when necessary? Because that's the issue with the Fukushima reactor, right? They've got these rods that are still going, and they got to figure out, you know, what to do about that.
Right, you can't really stop the radiation once it starts going.
So apparently you can if thorium is involved. So it also apparently produces waste products that are less radioactive and generates more energy per ton. So why on earth are we using uranium? As you may recall, research into the mechanization of nuclear reactions was initially driven not by the desire to make energy, but by the desire to make bombs. The $2 billion Manhattan Project that produced the atomic bomb sparked a worldwide surge in nuclear research, most of it funded by governments embroiled in the Cold War.
And let me guess, thorium doesn't explode.
And here we come to it. Thorium reactors do not produce plutonium, which is what you need to make a nuke.
That's pretty terrible. I mean, I think I remember learning about this at one point. Plutonium, supposedly, just like one little speck of it, if you breathe it in, can cause lung cancer. So it's terribly toxic.
So how ironic. The fact that thorium reactors could not produce fuel for nuclear weapons meant that the better reactor fuel got short shrift. Yet today, we would love to be able to clearly differentiate a country's nuclear reactors from its weapons program. In the post-Cold War world, is there any hope for thorium? Perhaps, but don't run to your broker just yet. The typical nuclear fuel cycle starts with refined uranium ore, which is mostly U-238, but contains 3% to 5% U-235. Most naturally occurring uranium is U-238, but this common isotope does not undergo fission, which is the process whereby the nucleus splits and releases tremendous amounts of energy. By contrast, the less prevalent U-235 is fissile. As such, to make reactor fuel, we have to expend considerable energy enriching yellow cake to boost its proportion of U-235. Once in the reactor, U-235 starts splitting and releasing high-energy neutrons. The U-238 doesn't just sit idly by, however. It transmutes into other fissile elements. When an atom of U-238 absorbs a neutron, it transmutes into the short-lived U-239, which rapidly decays into Neptunium-239, and then into Plutonium-239, that lovely, weaponizable byproduct. So when the U-235 content burns down to 0.3%, the fuel is spent, but it contains some very radioactive isotopes of americium, technetium, and iodine, as well as plutonium. This waste fuel is highly radioactive, and the culprits, these high-mass isotopes, have half-lives of many thousands of years. As such, the waste has to be housed for up to 10,000 years. And we've all heard the stories of, you know, nuclear waste being trucked out to fields in Nevada in the desert and, you know, stored away.
Some mountain like in Utah somewhere.
The bottom of the bedrock in the mountains.
So, cloistered away from the environment and from anyone who might want to get at the plutonium for nefarious reasons. Thorium's advantages start from the moment it is mined and purified, in that all but a trace of naturally occurring thorium is Th-232, the isotope useful in nuclear reactors. That's a heck of a lot better than the 3 to 5% of uranium that comes in the form that we need. So all but a trace of thorium is useful, unlike the uranium. Then there's the safety side of thorium reactions. Unlike U-235, thorium is not fissile. That means that no matter how many thorium nuclei you pack together, they will not on their own start splitting apart and exploding. If you want to make thorium nuclei split apart, though, it's easy. You simply start throwing neutrons at them. Then, when you need the reaction to stop, simply turn off the source of neutrons, and the whole process shuts down. Simple as pie.
That seems easier than pie, because pie, you got to like make the crust and then add cinnamon to your apples and this and that. And it's rather difficult.
So a little more science here for you. That's here's how it works. When the Th-232 absorbs a neutron, it becomes Th-233, which is unstable and decays into protactinium-233 and then into U-233. That's the same uranium isotope we use in reactors now as a nuclear fuel, the one that's fissile all on its own.
Thankfully, it's also relatively long-lived, which means at this point in the cycle, the irradiated fuel can be unloaded from the reactor and the U-233 separated from the remaining thorium. The uranium is then fed into another reactor all on its own to generate energy. The U-233 does its thing, splitting apart and releasing high-energy neutrons. But there isn't a pile of U-238 sitting by. Remember, with uranium reactors, it's U-238 turned into 239 by absorbing some of those high-flying neutrons that produces all the highly radioactive waste products. With thorium, the U-233 is isolated, and the result is far fewer highly radioactive, long-lived byproducts. Thorium nuclear waste only stays radioactive for 500 years instead of 10,000. And there's 1,000 to 10,000 times less of it to start with. So far less radioactive waste from thorium, and it doesn't stay radioactive for near as long as the plutonium byproduct.
Right. And you can't kill people with it.
Well, I mean, if it's still radioactive... And I mean, like, 500 years in comparison to, like, 20,000, that is much better. But still, that doesn't really hold much importance as far as our lifespan goes. Like, we'll never be able to see the end of this radioactivity. Plus, if thorium starts becoming more popular, we'll have more of a buildup of the radioactive product. So, I mean, maybe it could
1,000 to 10,000 times less of the output of the, you know, the,
right, but
the radioactive product. That's a lot less.
If we start using that much more proportionally, though, then it could, you know, be a similar end product.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-453. But regardless, everything about it's better. It's not as dangerous, and you can stop the reactions instantaneously. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Are you ready to surrender your right to buy body armor? No joke. Congress is now trying to outlaw civilian body armor. And if House Bill H.R. 5344 becomes law, you can kiss your right to protect yourself against rifle bullets goodbye. Don't put off your body armor purchase any longer. Go now to InfidelBodyArmor.com. Thousands of military veterans trust their lives to Infidel Body Armor. You should too. Spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
Next to water and food, you need a safe, storable fuel supply for your preparedness needs. Spare fuel is the answer. Spare fuel can be used in any gas-powered vehicle or generator. Spare fuel is perfect for any unforeseen out-of-gas emergencies. Unlike gasoline, spare fuel is safe to store with your other supplies, and it can be stored for many years. Go to GetSpareFuel.com for special pricing. That's GetSpareFuel.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything that you want. We're talking about alternative energy. In this case, we've moved on to nuclear energy, and an alternative in the nuclear world is thorium, compared to what we're used to, which is uranium-based reactors, which, of course, if you know about the Fukushima development, this what happened a couple of years ago now, two, 3 years ago, I think, at this point. Out in Japan, it was pretty bad, you know, where that meltdown happened. It made it very difficult to contain, as I understand it. I don't know if the rods are still going or whatever.
There was no way to contain it.
Yeah.
It just, it seeped into the ocean, and there's no way to stop those rods from reacting. I mean, the uranium's already activated, so it's going to keep going until it runs out of fuel.
So I have to say, this is a really informative article. I'm not an expert on, you know, energy matters, and I like, you know, the way Forbes is explaining this makes it graspable for me, at least, especially learning that the reason why uranium is used, even though thorium is arguably a far better reactant, if you will, material, there you go. Element, how about that?
Element.
Far better element for this purpose. The reason why uranium was used was because of the Manhattan Project, because of the research into blowing people up. That uranium was better for that because it produces, they're off the byproduct, if you will, of plutonium, which thorium does not do, and thorium is much safer, and so they...
Does it have something to do with how slowly it reacts? Because I know uranium has a very, like, powerful, instantaneous reaction, which is how they create a bomb out of it.
No, I don't...
It said one of the byproducts of the uranium nuclear fuel is plutonium.
It's plutonium. You don't get that from thorium.
And plutonium is what they put in the nuclear bombs to blow things up.
I'm just saying, does thorium react slower? Does it
give off... That's not indicated here. By all the indicators here, it's a similar reaction. It's just a different...
A different type of reaction.
Yeah. It just it doesn't... It's not... It is, was it fissile was the term that they used, meaning that it can be stopped simply by, all they have to do is turn off the neutrons that are being thrown at it, and then the reaction stops. So it would not have this problem that we have with the uranium reactors where the rods are just continuing to react because they are out of control, because you can control it with this. So we're going to continue here with the Forbes piece because I think it's pretty interesting. And the title of the piece here is Why It May Not Get a Chance. We haven't gotten to that detail yet here, but we'll continue in moments. And also, we talked earlier about Bitcoin. Maybe you're ready to get some. Maybe you haven't done this yet. Maybe you are ready to get more Bitcoin. Go to expresscoin.com, whether you're just jumping in for the first time or you're a return customer, you've had Bitcoin before. You know that ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, as well as some of the alternative currencies out there like Dogecoin, Litecoin, Blackcoin, and Darkcoin. It's very easy. It's simple to go set up your account at ExpressCoin.com, and then you can buy Bitcoin with money order, check, wire transfer, and even cash deposit. And you can get it for no fee if you order less than $40 worth and use code FTL, FTL like Free Talk Live. You can do it from the United States or Canada. And again, it's an easy thing. Plus, they've even got a smartphone app that you can download at expresscoin.com. Use code FTL if you're ordering less than $40 worth to get it for no fee. And if you do more than $40 worth, it's a hell of a deal. It's only 3% transaction fee, which is the best price I think you're going to find anywhere to buy Bitcoin. So again, that's expresscoin.com. As we continue here with a piece from Forbes magazine on thorium. Researchers have studied thorium-based fuel cycles for 50 years. One of the other things we found out was that the nuclear waste from thorium is less radioactive. It only stays radioactive for 500 years. And there's 1,000 to 10,000 times less of it to start with. From any given reaction amount that you begin with, you get far less. 1,000 to 10,000 times less.
So there's less byproducts.
Correct. Researchers have studied thorium-based fuel cycles for 50 years, but India leads the pack when it comes to commercialization. As home to a quarter of the world's known thorium reserves and notably lacking in uranium resources, it's no surprise that India envisions meeting 30% of its electricity demand through thorium-based reactors by 2050. In 2002, India's Nuclear Regulatory Agency issued approval to start construction of a 500-megawatt electric prototype fast breeder reactor, which should be completed this year. Now, this was written in 2012.
What is a fast breeder reactor?
I'm looking to Ellen because I have no clue.
Oh, gee, I don't know. that was just kind of thrown at me. While you guys are
Googling
that.
Look it up. We'll figure that out.
I have an article about thorium here, and it says there's, as far as just known thorium reserves, India has 360,000 tons. Mm. And in second place, Australia with 300,000. And then
now,
United
is that
States
what they've already mined? That's already
no, that's
out?
Just known thorium reserves. Okay. So they know it's there, but they haven't. It's not available yet.
I see.
So they've just kind of taken stock. But if you want to compare that to what the United States has, we only have 160,000 tons of known thorium. So we're kind of halfway there. You know, if we end up producing ways to like mine and efficiently use thorium, then we might end up like having to buy it from other countries at some point.
In the next decade, construction will begin on six more of these fast breeder reactors, which breed uranium-233 and plutonium from thorium and uranium. Design work is also largely complete for India's first advanced heavy water reactor, an AHWR, which will involve a reactor fueled primarily by thorium that has gone through a series of tests in full-scale replica. The biggest holdup at present is finding a suitable location for the plant, which will generate 300 megawatts. I presume that's what MW in caps means. Indian officials say they are aiming to have the plant operational by the end of the decade. China is the other nation with a firm commitment to develop thorium power. In early 2011, China's Academy of Sciences launched a major research and development program on liquid fluoride thorium reactor technology, which utilizes U-233 that has been bred in a liquid thorium salt blanket. This molten salt blanket becomes less dense as temperatures rise, slowing the reaction down in a sort of built-in safety catch. This kind of thorium reactor gets the most attention in the thorium world, and China's research program is in the race with similar, though smaller, programs in Japan, Russia, France, and the U.S.
So I have gone to the Wikipedias, which I know it's not the most accurate website to get information, but it does say that fast breeder reactors use some sort of stuff called transuranic from fertile uranium-238. A fast spectrum is flexible enough that it can also breed fissile uranium-233 from thorium. So you can put thorium in this thing and wind up getting
and
out
get the,
uranium.
The useful form of uranium that you can stop from reacting. There are at least seven types of reactors that can use thorium as a nuclear fuel, five of which have entered into operation at some point. Several were abandoned not for technical reasons, but because of a lack of interest for research funding. Blame the Cold War again, says Forbes. So proven designs for thorium-based reactors exist and need but for some support. I think there's something wrong with that. Exist and need but for some support. Anyway, well, maybe quite a bit of support. But one of the biggest challenges in developing a thorium reactor is finding a way to fabricate the fuel economically. Making thorium dioxide is expensive, in part because its melting point is the highest of all oxides at 3,300 degrees Celsius. The options for generating the barrage of neutrons needed to kickstart the reaction regularly come down to uranium or plutonium, bringing at least part of the problem full circle. And while India is certainly working on thorium, not all of its eggs are in that basket. India has 20 uranium-based nuclear reactors producing 4,385 megawatts of electricity already in operation and has another 6 under construction, 17 planned and 40 proposed. The country gets props for its interest in thorium as a homegrown energy solution, but the majority of its nuclear money still is going towards traditional uranium. China is in exactly the same situation. While it promotes its efforts in the race, its big bucks are behind uranium reactors. China has only 15 reactors in operation, but has 26 under construction, 51 planned, and 120 proposed. And again, that's of uranium style. Thorium is 3 times more abundant in nature than uranium. All but a trace of the world's thorium exists as the useful isotope, which means it does not require enrichment. Thorium-based reactors are safer because the reaction can be easily stopped and because the operation does not have to take place under extreme pressures. Compared to uranium reactors, thorium reactors produce far less waste, and the waste that is generated is much less radioactive and much shorter lived. We'll talk a little bit more about this and get your thoughts coming up at 855-450-FREE.
Oh, fall. A time for cooler temperatures and hot deals from America's Best Value Inn. Save 15% when you book a room online at americasbestvalueinn.com and stay now through October 23rd. Plus, you'll enjoy free continental breakfast, internet, and instant rewards through our Value Club at most of our 1,000 hotels in North America. Fall into savings this season at America's Best Value Inn.
Bellawood Flooring has changed its finishing process. So for the first time ever, Lumber Liquidators is clearing out their current stock of Bellawood at unbelievable prices. Get Bellawood Red Oak Solid pre-finished hardwood for an incredible $2.99 per square foot. That's over 30% off already low prices. Even stunning solid Bellawood Bolivian Rosewood for an amazing 51% off. These are not seconds. This is first quality with a transferable 100-year warranty. So go to LumberLiquidators.com today to find the store nearest you. Special 18-month financing is available. But hurry, these clearance deals end Tuesday.
Question: could too many GMO foods and toxins be overloading your digestive and immune systems? Answer: yes. If you're searching for a powerful detox that's gentle enough to use every day, use Pro-EM1 from Terriganix. Pro-EM1 is a powerful liquid probiotic that uses good bacteria to suppress pathogens and gently eliminate toxins from your body. A healthy digestive system will cleanse and remove toxins, support weight loss, improve absorption of food nutrients, and aid in controlling yeast and other infections. Pro-EM1 is made with only non-GMO and certified organic ingredients, has no preservatives, and is dairy, soy, wheat, and gluten-free. Pro-EM1 is the key to your digestive health. Order Pro-EM1 Daily Probiotic Cleanse at Terraganix.com, spelled Terraganix.com, or call toll-free 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Also available through Amazon Prime. Pro-EM1 from Terraganix. Life's getting better.
Email is easy, instant, and free, and that can be real embarrassing. Email lacks the eye contact and body language you get in face-to-face conversation, or the tone of voice and other nuance you hear in a telephone conversation. Email is just words, often few words. We're all smothering in spam, so we often reply in terse fashion that's easy to misunderstand. And email doesn't cost you a postage stamp, and it lacks the deliberation time it'd take to walk to the snail mailbox, so it's easy to succumb to the "oh yeah" stimulus response trap. When in doubt, don't snap back at snippy messages you get. You may have mistaken the sender's intent, and unless you're sending AOL to AOL, there's no unsend. For more tips on critical communication skills for the way things are now, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything here toll free, 855-450-FREE. Thorium is on the table for discussion. There's a neat article over at Forbes that we were talking earlier about alternative energies, led to a conversation about nuclear energy. And thorium is an interesting alternative and arguably all around better alternative to uranium, which is an incredibly dangerous thing to use when it comes to nuclear fission, if you will. And now, to be fair, the history of nuclear power is one that's a relatively safe history, with a few exceptions.
Up
here
until about now.
Chernobyl. Three Mile Island.
Yeah, and then Fukushima. So there are a few incidents that are pretty horrible, but generally it's overall pretty safe stuff. But what they're pointing out here is that thorium is actually a lot safer. And there's a neat little summary here in the very end of the story from Forbes, which, by the way, you can get the full story over on our Facebook, Google+, and Twitter. Go to news.freetalklive.com to find all of those. But here's the kind of the recap. Then I want to get your thoughts toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Thorium, they say here, is three times more abundant in nature than uranium, and all but a trace of the world's thorium exists as the useful isotope, which means it doesn't require enrichment. Thorium-based reactors are safer because the reaction can easily be stopped, which is the big deal with the Fukushima thing. Those rods keep going, and that's a problem. And because the operation doesn't have to take place under extreme pressures. Compared to uranium reactors, thorium reactors produce far less waste, and the waste that is generated is much less radioactive and shorter-lived. To top it all off, thorium would also be the ideal solution for allowing countries like Iran or North Korea to have nuclear power without worrying whether their nuclear programs are just a cover for developing weapons.
Here's the way that you can actually tell on that is because the fuel-grade uranium is processed to a different percentage than weapons-grade uranium. And medical-grade uranium for, like, chemotherapy and radiation, stuff along those lines, is processed a lot less than fuel-grade uranium.
Okay.
So what they're doing over in Iran is they have already said, we will not process any fuel-grade uranium anymore. We will only do the medical grade. But the U.S. government is still saying, it's a cover for building a bomb.
So should we run out and invest in thorium? Unfortunately, no, says Forbes. For one, there are very few investment vehicles. Most thorium research and development is conducted by national research groups. There is one publicly traded company working to develop thorium-based fuels called Lightbridge Corporation. They have the advantage of being a first mover in the area, but on the flip side, the scarcity of competitors is a good sign. It's simply too early. Had it not been for mankind's seemingly insatiable desire to fight, thorium would have been the world's nuclear fuel of choice. Unfortunately, the Cold War pushed nuclear research toward uranium, and the momentum gained in those years has kept uranium far ahead of its lighter, more controllable, more abundant brother to date. History is replete with examples of an inferior technology beating out a superior competitor for market share, whether because of marketing or geopolitics, and once that stage is set, it's near impossible for the runner-up to make a comeback. Remember beta VCRs, anyone? On the technical front, they beat VHS hands down, but VHS's marketing machine won the race, and beta slid into oblivion. Thorium reactors aren't quite the beta VCRs of the nuclear world, but the challenge they face is pretty similar. It's damn hard to unseat the reigning champ.
All we need to do is convince the porn industry to build a thorium nuclear reactor, because it's because of porn that people use VHS instead
of beta. Is that right?
Beta.
Was that because porn chose to be on VHS as opposed to beta?
Yes.
I wonder why.
I don't know. Probably price? I'm not really sure.
So this might sound kind of like a thick question, but what is beta?
Oh, Daryl, can you explain that?
Betamax was a competitor to VHS. And
back in the old days.
Back in the old days, back when I was just a little kid.
I remember 70s. Being at the video stores and seeing them both.
So do I, yeah. But you know, it was one of those technologies to where, you know, late 70s, early 80s was the VHS beta wars.
Right, back when VHS, you've seen VHS decks, I'm sure.
Oh, yes. I used to own an entire like box full of VHS tapes.
Have you ever seen a top-loading VHS player where you load the, it's like this thing
yes.
that pops up
mm-hmm.
out of the top and you load in there? Yeah. Old school.
So a lot of television stations actually continued using beta until
some
just
still
recently.
Do. Yeah.
Yeah, and I'm sure that there are some that still do because the resolution and the quality is a lot better.
Is it like the same shape and setup in there?
Yeah,
like,
similar. I think the beta tapes were a little bit smaller, if I'm recalling correctly.
But what it broadcast on the television, yeah, it was the same, you know, resolution what you would see on
right,
TV.
But it was like the setup was the same. It was a hollow plastic thing with the tape.
A cartridge
going,
thing. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Just use different machines and different.
So it was Sony versus
tapes.
JVC, right? Didn't JVC come up with VHS and Sony
that
was beta?
Sounds right.
Yeah. Didn't work out for beta. Anyway, let's go to your phone calls and thoughts. Habu is on the line in Madison. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Habu.
Yeah, good evening to you, and thank you for the courtesy.
Sure.
You know, just one thing for your third host who didn't know about beta. Sony at that time was at the top of its game, and anything Sony came out with was really a light years ahead. And so even in spite of it, it lost it. So it just tells you how strong the marketing was. But going to thorium, I'm so glad you mentioned the story because these are some of the enlightening moments that Free Talk Live showers upon the waves, the ether. It was very good to hear this. I had known about thorium, and I believe the research had been done in either Norway or Switzerland and also in India. And I suppose that the tie-in with uranium and the Cold War was the big catch, and that's what kept you know, the research going into uranium as opposed to thorium.
It's tragic.
But the advantages of thorium are really so many, and also the another thing which I don't think I heard you mention, but it may be in the article, is the legacy of uranium. You know, you have this poisons produced at the end, you've got to dispose of it.
Mm-hmm.
And I think thorium's is much much less poisonous, and also the half-life is a fraction of it.
That's
and
right.
Then just one more point, please. You know, you mentioned something about, you know, when it comes to Iran or North Korea building these nuclear reactors. I mean, have these countries gone around attacked other countries in the world? Why is it that people somehow associate these nations, and I have no connection to either one of them, they should not have nuclear reactors? What's the problem with that? And I'm very sorry to hear that people like you, who are supposedly enlightened, are kind of perpetrating this myth again.
Well, I don't think we perpetrated that myth. The Forbes articles.
Well, why did you say this thing about Iran and North Korea?
We didn't perpetrate that myth.
Fox News can say it, but why do you say it?
We didn't. The Forbes article.
Ian read something out of the Forbes article. That was not Ian's opinion.
Then we proceeded to discuss that.
Right.
Oh, okay. I stand. I apologize. I thought that was you just throwing out that line there.
No. Ian had read something out of the Forbes article, and then I dispelled that.
I'm sorry.
Okay. No problem. Apology accepted. Anything else you want to share?
No, that's all. But I'm so you know that's the only way out from this global warming Damocles sword of hanging over our heads. That's the only way out, really. That
you mean
kind of,
thorium reactors?
Well, thorium together with, you know, wind power and other mm-hmm. a portfolio made up of a number of types of sources, but primarily I would say thorium.
Thank you, Habu. I appreciate your call tonight. The other thing about beta versus VHS that I was recalling, but I went to just double check on the Wikipedia article about beta. One of the big negatives to beta, you're right, Daryl, it was technically superior in that the picture quality would be better of a beta tape than VHS, but you couldn't hold as much on beta as you could VHS. And so it says here in the story that in 1977, Sony came out with the first long play Betamax VCR, which had two recording speeds, which provided 2 hours of recording time on the beta video, the standard beta video cassette, which they came out with this to compete with VHS. It already had 2 or 4 hours. So the default on beta was just an hour, which would mean that in order to show a full length feature film, you'd have had to have had two video cassettes. And that can be kind of
end
clunky.
End of cassette one. Please enter cassette two.
Right, and that's not really a big deal with CDs, but I can't imagine something more cubic, like a thing that you have to insert.
Well, it would mean that you'd have to do it, you know, you'd have to stop in the middle of a movie, pull the tape out, put a new one in order to continue the movie, and that would mean you'd have to rewind two cassettes rather than rewinding one cassette.
So much more time consuming.
Yeah, so that was a big negative, I think, for beta, and one of the, besides the porn thing, one of the reasons why it didn't work out. Hour three's on the way. It's Free Talk Live.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Stouffer's, helping bring your family together with wholesome dinner options, even on the busiest of nights. Find dinner table ideas to bring your family together at letsfixdinner.com. To get kids involved in dinner time conversation, ask specific questions, not broad ones. Instead of what happened today at school, try what was the best thing that happened today? The more specific you are, the more they'll have to say. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, September 26, 2014. Gold opened today at $1,212, silver opened at $17.52, and Bitcoin is trading around $399. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. Vote Michael Cargill to get the cars moving. Learn more or sign up to volunteer at CargillForTexas.com. Political advertisement paid for by the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. In the news today, 2 days before Attorney General Eric Holder announced his resignation, U.S. District Court Judge John D. Bates ruled that the Department of Justice must release details on documents related to Operation Fast and Furious. Judge Bates ruled that the Department of Justice must submit the materials sought by the watchdog group Judicial Watch no later than October 22nd. The judge called the government's request for more time unconvincing. The FBI director on Thursday criticized the decision by Apple and Google to encrypt smartphone data so it can be inaccessible to law enforcement even with a court order.
James Comey told reporters at FBI headquarters that U.S. officials were in talks with the two companies, which he accused of marketing products that would let people put themselves beyond the law's reach. While law enforcement is obviously perturbed that they will no longer be able to legally or illegally intercept people's data, privacy advocates are heralding the moves by the cell phone giants as an important step in the right direction. Hundreds of speeding tickets written by four disgraced Houston Police Department officers were dismissed after their ticket falsification scheme was exposed. Randy Zamora, chief of the Criminal Law Division for the City of Houston Legal Department, said it was in the interest of justice and simply the right thing to do to dismiss the tickets. The I-team of KHOU in Houston first revealed that officers Rudolph Farias, John Garcia, Robert Manzanellis, and Gregory Rosa were listing each other as witnesses for speeding violations, despite the officers not being present. The gang of four were allegedly seeking to collect more overtime pay for court appearances. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Cabo Bob's, Southwestern-style burritos. Now with two locations in Austin, 500 East Ben White Boulevard and 2828 Rio Grande Boulevard. Find them online, cabobobs.com. And support also comes from Sovereign Living, a podcast, blog, and reality show about what it takes to live a voluntary and natural life. Check out the blog at sovereignliving.com and watch episode one of the soon-to-be-released reality show at sovereignliving.tv. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, September 26, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook, facebook.com/thelibertybeat. The controversial practice of spraying the skies to alter the weather has recently come under fire. Activists around the planet will spread awareness about the issue of geoengineering tomorrow, Saturday. Businesses like Weather Modification Incorporated claim to increase precipitation, mitigate hail, and disperse fog with plane and ground-based aerosol sprayers, a process known as cloud seeding. The Weather Modification Association claims the practice of cloud seeding began in 1940 and no negative health effects have been found. This weekend, individuals concerned about the health effects of the weather-altering chemicals being sprayed are attending screenings of documentaries, participating in educational marches, and hosting lectures across the globe. The Austin, Texas event takes place tomorrow at noon at the Texas State Capitol. Visit gmacag.com to find a march in your area. Well, this weekend is full of Central Texas Liberty action for both anarchists and politicos. Alliance of Austin Agorists will hold their ninth networking party this Friday evening from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. at Brave New Books. Don't miss the opportunity to speak with four of Austin's finest crypto geniuses. Michael Goldstein, Justice Ranveer, Daniel Krawitz, and Jonathan Rumyan will each give a talk on what crypto anarchy and agorism means to them and why it matters. Be sure to enjoy the farmer's market, free beer, and live music. Then on Monday, Texans for Accountable Government will be hosting a city council candidate forum and meet and greet. Austinites will have a chance to get FaceTime with candidates running in their district, as well as to get answers to the tough questions. The event will be held at Sherlock's Baker Street Pub on Research Boulevard from 6 to 9 p.m. More information at tagtexas.org. Today's edition of the Liberty Beat, brought to you by Brave New Books, your source for One World Way, Tangy Tangerine, and clearly filtered fluoride filters. Located in Austin, Texas, 1904 Guadalupe Street, or online at bravenewbookstore.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, September 26, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting.
Hours spent volunteering at a local homeless shelter truly make her death at the hands of a drunk driver earlier this week all the harder to take for this school and this community.
I never knew Amanda, but everywhere I went, there were touching reminders of the caring friend she would have been to me had I known her.
Losing Amanda was one of the hardest things I've ever had to deal with, but I knew I had to be strong for this community. I couldn't let them go through the funeral without my support.
She's so much better than all of us. She was so much good. She cared about so many people. She loved you so much. What's your name? She loved you, Russell.
And we have O'Brady Shaw with us right now.
Thanks, Brooke.
Not quite how I would have reported the story. Seems a bit unprofessional to let yourself get so emotional.
Well, when people are feeling pain, I feel it too. Don't you ever get emotionally invested in a story?
No, I don't. You know, I had my tear ducts cauterized years ago, and I like to keep my emotions stored in a special place in my mind where they only come out for my night terrors.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. inviting you to take control of the airwaves toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Thorium versus uranium, Betamax versus VHS. Whatever you want to talk about here on Free Talk Live. Those are some of the things we've been discussing here
Thor
tonight.
Thor wins, hands down.
Thor?
Thorium is named
god
after
of
Thor.
Thunder.
Was it really?
The god of thunder.
I didn't know that.
Yes.
Okay. So, yeah, we talk about whatever you want here. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE. And the Wii tonight includes me, Ian.
Ellen.
And Daryl.
And I don't know what they named Betamax after, but if you really want to know, we could probably find that
the
out.
The fish, maybe?
I don't know. I think it's something else. I was actually just looking
or
at the Wikipedia.
Or maybe it's the Greek letter?
There is a Greek letter involved. Wikipedia, I believe, has the answer there. We'll go to your calls and thoughts here, and if we get the chance, we can talk about a man who has hung himself because of frustrations over what the government was doing to him. Plus, Daryl has a story about revenge porn that we have yet to get to. But first, we go to Paul on Skype. Our Skype username, by the way, is lrn.fm. Go ahead, Paul. You are on the air. Do we have Paul? Paul in I don't know where. Paul going once. Paul going twice. You know what? Sometimes there's an issue with my computer's sound card, and I don't know how the hell to fix it beyond resetting it. Looks like my sound card's okay, so it must be Paul. All right, so we'll check back with Paul here in a little bit. Maybe he went was in the bathroom or something. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Oh, so I mentioned earlier we were talking about garbage, and there's just a quick story here out of Seattle where apparently it's now going to be a finable offense to put too much food in your garbage can.
Well, what if it's a compost can?
That's what they want you to compost.
You wouldn't have a can that they would throw out, right? Do they have compost cans that are collected by the city?
No. I don't think they do now.
No, this would be for what you put out on the curb.
Oh, okay.
So the idea is they're going to be able to sift around through your garbage and determine whether or not
you've... What a waste of time. Why would they spend... Like, doesn't that lose them money if they're sifting through your trash? Like...
They're government employees. They don't care about efficiency.
How are they going to decide how much? Like, are they going to weigh each trash and, like, decide the proportions? Like, this much is food and this much is...
I think they're just going to eyeball it. According to the story here, the Seattle Times, they have passed at the city council a new ordinance that would mean fines for people who toss too many table scraps into the trash. Under the current SPU, Seattle Public Utilities rules, people living in single-family homes are encouraged but not required to dispose of food waste and compostable paper products in compost bins. Apartment buildings must have compost bins available, but residents of apartment buildings aren't required to use them, and businesses are not subject to any composting requirements. Under the new rules, however, collectors can take a cursory look each time they dump trash into a garbage truck. If they see compostable items making up 10% or more of the trash, they will enter the violation into a computer system that their trucks already carry and will leave a ticket on the garbage bin that says to expect a $1 fine on their next garbage bill.
Is that an eyeball 10% by volume or 10% by weight?
I don't think they're gonna be weighing it, so I think they're just gonna be eyeballing it.
Right, but are they bait? You know what version of 10% are they using? Because you know,
no,
like
that's not
a
specified.
Banana peel is going to be you know longer than say like a folded up napkin.
Yeah,
and would weigh more, but. You know, an orange peel is going to be smaller and weigh less than, say, a pizza box.
I don't know how they're going to do it, Daryl. I would just say it's just going to be some garbage man looking at your trash and determining whether or not, arbitrarily, whether or not it's more than 10%.
Everybody get a fine.
Apartment buildings and businesses will be subject. And, of course, there's no way you'll be able to you know, challenge
dispute
it.
Dispute it.
Right.
The trash is gone.
Are you going to take it to court and be like, hey, I didn't. Do you have photo evidence of
take
this trash?
Take pictures of all of the trash right. that you put in your can.
Yeah, that's just it. There's no way to challenge it because the trash is gone. The evidence in this case has been disposed of. Apartment buildings and businesses.
Ooh, you could then potentially, and of course this is not legal advice, but potentially you could get the ticket thrown out because the evidence was destroyed.
That's true. But most people won't take these things to court, and they probably won't know how if they could take them to court to do so. They're as always, the government counts on your ignorance and your willingness to or your unwillingness to go through the difficulty of the court process to avoid this. Plus, who's going to want to go to court over a dollar fine? They're
right.
Just
how far
it.
Are they going to push this petty fining?
Oh, they'll keep pushing it because apparently a third violation will result in a $50 fine. So it sounds like it's no big deal up front, but it's not.
$5, $5, $50.
Yeah. Well, $1, $1, and then $50. Dumpsters, they say, will be checked by inspectors on a random basis at apartment buildings and businesses. Now, it's not made clear. The $50 fine thing is listed in the same paragraph as the apartment buildings and businesses, so maybe that doesn't apply to single-family homes. It's not made real clear. Collectors will begin tagging garbage bins and dumpsters with educational tickets starting on January 1st when they find violations, but fines won't start until July 1st.
Wait, don't you think they would make more money if they went after places like restaurants? You know, like, I'm sure someplace like Olive Garden throws away hundreds of pounds of food every single day.
Well, I don't think, let's see, businesses will be subject. So yeah, I guess restaurants are going to have to start ponying up here. That, unless they're exempted.
Or composting and selling their old food and actually making money off of it, which wouldn't be a bad idea. But I still think that this whole regulation thing is ridiculous.
I don't know. And
how are they
going
to determine too much?
And a lot of places there are regulations against restaurants giving food to homeless people. There's probably some corporate policy about, you know, don't give away whatever's left over, because then it would, you know, wind up encouraging people to make sure that they cook a little extra so I get to take home a big giant bowl of linguine because I cooked a little extra, ha ha ha. So it's really going to be interesting to see how the businesses wind up responding to this.
Well, according to the SPU's director, Tim Kroll, he says that they don't expect to collect many fines. They say the city outlawed recyclable items from the trash 9 years ago, but since then they've collected less than $2,000 in fines. He says the point isn't to raise revenue. We care more about reminding people to separate their materials. SPU asked the council to consider a new ordinance because the agency is falling short of its recycling and composting goals. Their recycling rate for 2013 was 56%. A slight improvement over 2012, but not on pace to meet their goal of 60% for 2015.
So, just real quick, it said in the last 9 years, they've only collected
$2,000.
$2,000 worth of fines. Is that because people aren't paying the fines or they're not writing the tickets?
It's not making that clear.
They're probably not writing the tickets because they have to search through the trash. And this is probably going to end up in a similar scenario where they're not making a lot of money off of it, really, but they're not really writing the tickets for it just because nobody wants to spend the time searching through trash. I mean, maybe I'm wrong, but it seems to me like, you know, they're not actually going to spend all that time. Like, yes, they want to encourage people to recycle more, but they just want to make the law and then kind of, like, forget about it. That's what they do with, you know, most of these petty ordinances anyway.
Well, they're saying here that collectors are already checking garbage bins regularly for recyclable items. So they're already sifting through people's garbage looking to issue fines. They just aren't allegedly writing very many of them. And I think it comes back to what you were talking about earlier, Daryl, with this episode of Penn & Teller's BS, where they brought out bin after bin after bin and kept introducing this homeowner, this, you know, guy who didn't know that he was on a hidden camera, you know, setup, kept introducing new bins for him to put things into, separating, more separation. And because people have been trained so effectively to believe that this is necessary to save the world, that, you know, they're more than happy to do it, right? So that's why that it's going to go relatively smoothly. And of course, it's Seattle, which is sort of got that lefty flavor to it in the first place. SPU claims this new law will generate 38,000 tons in additional compost annually, he says. And so again, they're already looking through your trash if you're there in Seattle. The council, by the way, voted unanimously on this, 9-0. Now, the fines are starting at $1, but there's no reason why they can't raise those in another 10 years or 5 years or whatever to $10 next year.
Whatever.
Yeah, or next year. So tell me how you feel about this one. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I'm grateful I live in a place where the government doesn't pick up my garbage, where we can throw, you know, things out and it's not a problem here and everything's okay. And I'd rather have the market handle garbage disposal rather than have bureaucrats come up with arbitrary rules to try to encourage behavior. Let's come up with more persuasive methods to encourage behavior rather than fines and possible jail time. More coming up here on Free Talk Live.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com. Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live.
Now, I can understand why some people would look at what the mainstream environmental movement says and does and advocates and come to the conclusions that, well, some of these people seem to want humans to go back into caves.
They do.
But that's not to say that just because the most vocal environmental activists out there
are socialist nut jobs
are that way means that, we should just forget about taking care of the environment. Who wants pollution? Who wants any of that stuff? Right. What I want is market-based solutions that don't involve threatening violence against people, and that's what the government solution always is. The government doesn't persuade. The government doesn't ask. The government demands. And if you don't go along with their demands, they've got a nice cold concrete cage waiting for you.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll free and bring up anything. Revenge porn. Daryl's going to tell us about that. Apparently, one of the revenge porn laws is being challenged. We'll find out more here in a little bit. And if we get the chance, we'll tell you about a man who hung himself after frustration built for over a decade of being harassed by the local town bureaucrats here in right next door here to our Keene studios in New Hampshire. Our toll free.
Well, not right next door. Well, it was in a neighboring town.
Next door is in town over. Basically, two towns over. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And don't forget, join us online. Get interactive over at freetalklive.com. Now, if you need focus and are feeling fatigued and trying to get that extra edge when it counts, check out modafinil from modup.net. Studies show 1 in 5 students are using this cognitive enhancer, offering multiple benefits, including a double-digit increase in short-term memory, fighting off fatigue, and greater focus overall, so you can get things done. Businessmen are also talking about modafinil from modup.net and how it's making the difference in their work and giving them the critical edge they need. They make it affordable for everyone to take advantage of the benefits of modafinil by being 80 to 85% lower in price than the brand name. But don't mistake low prices for inferior quality. They ensure that purity and potency are consistent to that of the branded version. Now remember, Free Talk Live is an international radio show, and modup.net ships worldwide. It's your responsibility to know if local prescription requirements and laws apply. So go to modup.net, and if you pay with Bitcoin, you'll get an even better discount, 33% off. They're already low prices, and to make the deal even sweeter, use code FTL, like Free Talk Live, and you'll get 10 free tablets with your order. So again, that's code FTL at modup.net for world-class service on a great price for modafinil. Modup, modup.net, code FTL. Let's go to, we're going to try Paul on the line here in, I'm still not sure where he is, but he's on Skype, and he said he was muted last time, so now hopefully he is unmuted. Paul, are you with us?
Yeah, I'm here. Can you hear me?
I hear you, but unfortunately we're having more technical difficulties. I'm going to bring you back here in just a moment. Stand by, Paul. Meantime, Daryl, tell me, what is revenge porn?
So revenge porn, and there are actually several definitions, so I'm not really sure which one the correct definition is, but I'll go with the one that I've heard the most.
All right.
Revenge porn is when a couple had consensually made a pornographic film, and then after splitting up, one of the partners posted it online without the consent of the other partner.
Now, it may not be a film, it could just be photos, right? That
could also be photos, but I think most of the time it is video.
I don't know if that's true. I don't know if that's true, because I think it probably would be more common for a girlfriend or boyfriend to take nude photos of themselves and send those. So, for instance, not necessarily the actual sex act with two people, but naked pictures of oneself, say on like a vacation, or if you've got a long distance relationship,
true,
or something
true
like that, just because it'd be easier and faster to snap a photo and send that rather than record a full, you know, movie of something
right
happening.
Right.
But we'll get into what's going on here. I believe I've fixed the issues here. We're going to try Paul for the third and hopefully magical third time. Paul, are you back with us?
Yeah, I'm here.
You sound crisp. You sound clear.
Much better.
We can actually put you on the air this time. Go ahead, sir.
Okay. Awesome. Yeah. So I'm calling in about this Boston Strong video that I think Cantwell posted. Is that
Boston Strong? Yes, this is a person, not a slogan, but somebody that is called Boston Strong by some of the activists in the Keene area.
I don't think that this guy refers to himself in that manner.
Actually, from what I understand, he refers to himself as Boston.
Is that his Facebook name? Or is that his real name?
What his name on Facebook
just
is.
Just his alias, maybe.
I believe that is what he goes by among friends, and somehow he got called Boston Strong by some of the activists in the area because of his anger.
And I think he was wearing a Boston Strong t-shirt one day.
Okay.
Yeah, so this guy is a member of what is a group called Stop Free Keene, which is a local group of haters, people who are very angry about the liberty activists in the area, and they have organized to some extent to try to stop us. I'm not sure exactly how they plan on doing that, but apparently it has something to do with telling lies in a lot of cases and being very angry and spreading libel and misinformation.
And possibly stealing newspapers.
Possibly as well. So Boston Strong is one of those people, and he happens to live about 3 houses down from the LRN.FM studios, which is across the street.
That's unfortunate.
Which is across the street from Christopher Cantwell's house as well. And the Boston Strong video to which you refer is actually, as we speak, the top story at freekeen.com. Garrett Ian, one of the bloggers there, posted an opinion piece where he is not happy with the behavior of both Christopher Cantwell or Boston Strong. And so anyone who hasn't seen the video, you can just go to freekeen.com. It's right there right now. But I'll put a link in on our Facebook, Google+, and Twitter as well. What were your comments, Paul?
Well, it's more of a question. You know, I've been listening to you guys for a long time and kind of following the movement in Keene, I guess. And I remember when there was this Robin Hood controversy and people were kind of yelling at each other, and, you know, while the Robin Hooding was going on, which is saving people from meter tickets, if the listeners don't know. And mm-hmm. I remember there was kind of some heated words going on a couple years ago, and I correct me if I'm wrong, but I think that's when the Stop Free Keene thing kind of came about. But I didn't really, when I watched this video, I just didn't understand what was the leap, or what happened between these arguments sort of in the street over the meter maids to now people are driving by screaming, stealing a flag, allegedly, all of this, like what is going on? There's now all these people are involved doing stuff. Yeah,
sure. Okay. So let's see if we can recap briefly here for our listeners who may be just tuning in. Free Keene is a website that sort of catalogs activism in the Keene area as part of this movement of liberty loving people who've come here and have done various different types of activism. And Robin Hooding, as you mentioned, is one of them, which is, you know, sort of activism where you go and you save people from getting parking tickets. Well, it turns out some people like the parking tickets and they like the parking meter enforcers. And so they feel like the Robin Hooders are harassing the meter maids. And so they've made it their job to, you know, give us a taste of our own medicine is the idea. They want to harass us back is the idea. Now, of course, there's no harassment going on of the meter maids at all. That's a ridiculous claim. But I understand.
But even if there was,
yeah,
the Superior Court judge ruled that it is protected speech.
That's
because
true.
Their contract and their employment handbook says that they are to endure verbal and mental abuse.
Legally, that's true. I don't believe I'm mentally abusing or verbally abusing anybody, but obviously everybody has an opinion about that.
Well, you could believe that, but they could believe something differently.
Their opinion is different. Their opinion is that it is harassment and that they want to do something about it. So some people have gotten violent over this. Garrett Ian has been physically threatened multiple times and attacked on the streets while doing Robin Hooding by some of these thoughtless thugs, basically, locally. And it's no secret where the studio is here. It's no secret where the Keene Activist Center is. And so, you know, it's not like we're hiding. And so, therefore, this location has become the target, even though there are dozens of, you know, free staters, liberty activists in the Keene area. The one known location is this location. So, of course, it's going to be the target for theft and vandalism and for people shouting and screaming out in front of the house and things like that. We can continue with the discussion here in moments. Your calls and thoughts are welcome. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right. General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for under $30,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet under $30,000. Many manufacturers. If you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait.
Call 800-917-8251. 800-917-8251. 800-917-8251.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin? Any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, toll-free number for you, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can bring up anything that you'd like. We can talk more about revenge porn here in a moment. One of the revenge porn laws has apparently been challenged, and Daryl has that story. Also, you can join us online over at freetalklive.com. And if you are online at all, wherever it is, whether it's at home or at work, your laptop, your smartphone, you gotta get ProXPN to protect yourself. It's a global virtual private network which encrypts your data connection, meaning that your internet service provider, if you're using ProXPN, your ISP won't know what you're doing anymore. And right now, they're probably keeping records of every website you visit, every search you make, for in some cases, as long as 5 years. You can stop that from happening by going and getting ProXPN's free software over at proxpn.com/FTL. It's available for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, Android devices, plus Linux users. You can even get ProXPN set up as well. So proxpn.com/FTL. Use our promo codes when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account. You'll get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites as well. So proxpn.com/FTL. Use these codes, FTL50, to get 50% off the price of the annual account. That breaks down to about $5 a month. And also, that's a lifetime discount. That's not going to be some limited time deal. That's the lifetime of your account. You get that discount. Or get a better discount by paying with Bitcoin for the annual plan. You'll get 62% off if you use code FTLBTC. That's FTL like Free Talk Live and Bitcoin like, or BTC like Bitcoin. So it's a great discount on privacy that's priceless. Plus, you get a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, so you really have nothing to lose but your privacy. Go to proxpn.com/FTL. Codes are FTL50 and FTLBTC. We've got Paul with us here. He was curious to know more about the the video that's currently posted over at freekeen.com, and I will post it, or I did post it actually, to the Free Talk Live Facebook and Google Plus and Twitter, the Boston Strong conflict between our Wednesday night co-host Christopher Cantwell and local freedom hater Boston Strong. Now, you had asked what had precipitated this conflict. Well, Boston Strong had been driving by the LRN studios and the Keene Activist Center and Chris Cantwell's house and yelling, "Get a job!" at the top of his lungs on a daily basis. Now, it's all
multiple times a day.
Yeah, it's all he ever yells. He doesn't have any other insults that
maybe
he ever throws out.
His job is yelling, "Get a job," at everybody else. Like, somebody hired him to do that.
I doubt it. I think he's
said he was a plumber.
Yeah, he's a plumber for sure. He's got a real plumbing truck and things like that. But what brought this about is people being angry at the activism here. They hate all of the activism some of them hate all of the activism. Some of them might like some of it, but I don't know what they like because they don't ever talk about what they like. They talk about what they don't like. And they hate it, and they want to do something about it, and they are, there are only so many options of things they can do. They can get violent, they can get loud, and they can be obnoxious.
Right, they want to pretend like they're the good guys, so they don't really go out and like openly get violent. They just like to yell.
There are a few that have gotten violent, but most of them don't get violent. But yelling certainly is within the purview. Although ever since Chris Cantwell went over there and had his argument with Boston Strong, the yelling has stopped, at least from Boston Strong. He has not yelled since he's driven by in the first place. But none of this should be surprising or unexpected. I think a lot of people in the movement are looking at this and saying, "Oh, you people in Keene, see, you're clearly doing things wrong. People don't like you." Well,
but
guess what?
But we just resolved an issue.
What do you mean?
It means you're doing something right, I think.
What do you mean,
if people,
Ellen,
are getting upset? But you said that Boston Strong was yelling, and after having the discussion with Cantwell, now he doesn't yell.
Well, it was the police that came along, and discouraged him
police
from yelling.
Police that were called by one of the neighbors.
A neighbor.
Because they saw some people having a confrontation in the middle of the street or something.
The police didn't tell him that he couldn't yell. They just suggested that he stop yelling.
That's a little irritating. People can't even have a yelling match on their front lawn anymore without people calling the cops.
Well, I mean, who wants to have a bunch of people shouting out in front of their house at 10 o'clock at night? I guess it wasn't 10. It was like 7 at night when that happened. Who really wants that to happen? I mean, that's pretty disruptive and it's kind of trashy. I don't think that, I don't think that Chris was behaving very gentlemanly in this particular episode. But at the same time, I don't think he was wrong for wanting to go over and talk to the man who was screaming at the top of his lungs out in front of his house on a daily basis.
And obviously I don't know what was going through either person's mind, but based on having watched the video, I think when the police officer said, "Yeah, certainly you can yell at him every day, but he can also
come
stand
over
on your front, on the sidewalk in front of your house and yell at you to not yell at him."
And I don't think Boston Strong wants that to happen, so he discontinued.
I think that's what clicked in his head. Oh, wait, so, yeah,
they
I don't
can yell
this.
Too. So there
so
you go.
So he didn't expect anybody to stand up to him, is what you're saying.
Maybe.
Right. Hmm. But I've also seen to where some of the people in Stop Free Keene are somehow saying that this is Free Keene shutting down their freedom of speech.
So there you go, Paul. So you had said that you thought this was expected because it should be.
Yeah. To me, this really seems like on their part, the Stop Free Keene, it seems kind of like this roundabout ad hominem in a way, It's like they're not willing to do their own type of activism. They're really not willing to do anything except for attack the actual people.
That's correct. They did once upon a time in springtime come out and do a protest against us, essentially a counter protest, where I was really impressed. They got 21 people to come out and hold signs that were very anti-freedom, anti-Free Keene, anti-me, actually, in a lot of cases.
It's surprising they don't stand for anything, really. They just stand against anything that Free Keene does.
They have no ideas. And
it takes special gymnastics of logic to make sense of what they're saying.
And among the group, they have different political viewpoints, right? So some of them might be sort of lefty, some of them might be right, etc. One of them even claims claims to be a free stater who's in the Stop Free Keene group. So there's all kinds of different political perspectives in there as well. They don't all have the same idea. The only thing they have in common is that they don't like us. They don't like the liberty activists in the area. And of course, the liberty people, some people in the liberty movement, you know, there's always critics. They say, well, this is evidence you're doing it wrong. But in my opinion, this is evidence we're having an impact. Because if Free Keene, which is just a blog, you know, if Free Keene were to shut down tomorrow, it wouldn't stop the liberty movement from coming here and getting active. But the fact is we're having an impact, and people realize that, because if we weren't having an impact, if all we were was just, you know, some kids doing activism and no one cared about, then they wouldn't be responding in this way. But because we represent the potential for change, and because that potential is realistic, then I think that's the reason why that people are getting angry about it.
Right. And I think it lessens the potential when people who are, you know, fellow liberty supporters are arguing with people who are supposed to have similar, you know, similar desires, and they're saying, like, oh, you're doing it wrong. Why don't you try to do it the right way then? Like, instead
that's
of pointing out other people's flaws, why
or
don't
tell
you just
me
try
what
to
the right way is?
Yeah.
Other than just
teach
that
people,
different.
Something education. Else.
So, Paul, final thoughts. Go ahead.
Yeah, I just have one last question. Who is that jerk turkey calling a pedophile? Like, what's that about?
Oh, yeah, one of their favorite insults against me is to call me a pedophile because I have a girlfriend who is a teenager. And apparently they don't understand what a pedophile actually is. A pedophile is somebody who's attracted to children. And they of course, believe that the legal definition of a child is what a child is. Whereas
I think they do understand what it is. It's just that that's something that they feel like they can yell at you. You know, it's
sure.
just
to
like,
agitate you.
Yeah, they're intentionally taking something out of context, intentionally not understanding the situation because it suits their insults and their feelings or whatever.
Right, but I'm sure that if the legal age of adulthood was 27 and Ian was dating someone that was 26, they would still yell pedophile because, well, legally.
Yeah.
Right, there's some arbitrary number chosen.
Hey, Paul, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from
you.
The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. There is enough time for you with your thoughts. A pedophile definition of that is someone who is attracted to sexually a child, and the definition of a child is someone who has not hit puberty. That's not me. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. You can take control here in the remaining moments of Free Talk Live. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
A world without breast cancer is a world with more birthdays. And by signing up for the Making Strides Against Breast Cancer Walk, you will help us get there faster. Because you're helping the American Cancer Society make the greatest impact and save more lives in more communities through groundbreaking research and access to screenings for women who need them.
Walk in Making Strides Against Breast Cancer, because you can help us finish the fight. Sign up today at MakingStridesWalk.org.
Summertime is save big time at Herbal Healer Academy. Long-term customers know summer is the time to stock up at HerbalHealer.com. And for new customers, welcome to the web's best place to save on vitamins, minerals, and more. Log on for summer specials, including all sizes of colloidal silver, colloidal minerals, and intestinal freedom on sale. Choose from Herbal Healer's great variety of weight loss products like apple cider vinegar, Hoodia, and Metabolic Complex and Pro-Metabolic, all on sale now. Also, the anti-parasite Intestinal Freedom and Wormwood Plus Complex, plus Stevia Liquid Sweetener and the Super Enzymes, all on sale for summer at HerbalHealer.com. As always, we offer certificate correspondence courses in natural medicine. Enjoy same-day shipping and free online newsletter. Log on now to HerbalHealer.com and look for summer specials to save big with our nation's leader in supplying quality natural medicine and education since 1988. Herbal Healer Academy.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. Moments remain here, but enough time for you with your calls and thoughts. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we share with you. So enjoy. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. Free Talk Live is brought to you by Keenvention. You've heard about Keen and some of the activism that goes on here, but also the activism going on across New Hampshire as the Free State Project continues to move new liberty-loving people here who care about freedom enough to actually do something, to pick up their lives, as the three of us have done. We wouldn't know each other if it weren't for the Free State Project. And I'm so grateful that I know you guys. It's been great.
Oh, thanks, Ian.
Yeah. By the way, my name's Ian, and you are?
Ellen.
And I'm Daryl.
So we all moved here as part of the Free State Project, the idea to concentrate activism in one place. And guess what? When you concentrate activism in one place, your activism becomes more effective because you have more people doing more things. There's more variety out there. More people are trying different things, and some things are more effective at others. And sometimes when you have effective activism, people are going to get wind of it. And the people that love the state, the people, especially the ones that work for the state and the friends and family members of the ones that work for the state, well, guess what? They're not going to like it very much. They're not going to like that you're here doing these things, whether it's winning office, winning election, or whether it's doing civil disobedience, or whether it's simply holding parking enforcers accountable for their actions.
Or publishing a newspaper.
You've had your papers stolen, allegedly.
Out of 4 different newspaper boxes.
Well, don't you understand, Daryl? You're part of Free Keens, so therefore you must be bad.
Don't you give your paper out for free?
I do, but you know, generally a free newspaper means you take one, not all 200 that are in the bin.
Right, right. Well, there's really no way to regulate that, though. I mean, if they're all free, you have to expect somebody's going to abuse that.
Right, but you know, it's one of those known things of, you know,
unspoken
Ellen,
rules of
you,
society.
You don't take all 200 newspapers.
It'd be like me going into a restaurant and taking all of the ketchup packets.
That's
there,
right.
Yeah. There have actually been people that have done that and gotten arrested.
So in this case, Daryl has... you've come up with an interesting solution, or at least an idea. I don't know if it's going to be a solution, but
right. So I got the idea actually from one of the other people that lives here in Keene.
Another activist.
That worked for the college newspaper down at UMass. when he was in college down there, and they had a similar thing. It actually was not the official college newspaper. It was the alternative college newspaper.
Yep.
They ran an article that apparently was not friendly to the administration of the school, and people from the student government and the official newspaper took all of the newspapers. Mm. They called campus police. Campus police said, it's not theft because it's free. So they put something on their newspaper that said, first copy free, additional copies, $5. So then it makes taking more than one, taking a thing of value without permission.
Which is theft.
Which is theft.
So we're going to continue. Your calls are welcome. Our Skype username, lrn.fm, our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. But if you look at just regular politics, that's a nasty business. Anybody in regular politics who's done campaigning before knows that if you put out campaign signs, those things are going to get stolen. They're going to be mutilated, and that's common. It's a nasty, nasty game, and so no one should be surprised that even if you're not doing politics, if all you're doing is putting out a newspaper or some civil disobedience or protesting or whatever, that people are going to they're going to flip you the bird. They're going to yell, "Get a job." They're going to insult you. They're going to make things up about you. They're going to smear your character because you represent change. And people generally are uncomfortable with change. They feel like they're free already. This is a common statement made by some of the people in Stop Free Keene. Well, we don't appreciate them coming here to try to free us. We're already free.
I feel like it's more of an ego thing. If they were to allow you to spread your opinion, then they'd have to admit that they were wrong about something. And that's not something that people like to do.
People always like to
believe that they know everything already. They don't need your help.
They don't like that's change, and they don't want to be wrong. So you're absolutely right. And so some of them will lash out in very dangerous ways as a result of that. But I'm grateful that, nobody has been killed over this. There has been there was a young man who was pushed into a fountain earlier this year, who actually, in point of fact, was not a Free State Project participant. He was just a local who might have gotten a little bit into it with somebody in the park over some of these issues, and things got a little heated, and some thug came and pushed him into the fountain, which severely injured him, unfortunately.
Broke his neck, fractured a leg.
But if you think back to the 1960s and the movement for freedom back then, Martin Luther King and others, there were people who were killed, lynched.
Yeah,
those weren't uncommon.
Gladly, it hasn't reached that point yet, but right. I could see it escalating. If these events were allowed to continue going.
Well, they're going to continue. More people are going to move here, and more people are going to win election, and laws are going to, get repealed and changed, and, they can fight all they want. It's not going to stop the progress. People are going to come here, and if you're scared, then, you don't belong here in New Hampshire. You don't belong doing activism if you're afraid of what might happen to you as a result of some people being angry, because even if you think that you're safe doing politics, you're not safe doing politics, because if you start to have an impact in politics, then they'll arrest you. They'll manufacture reasons to come after your business. They'll find zoning violations at your home or your business. They'll target you in whatever way they can, even if it's not, direct threats to your person. So you got to expect that stuff when you get into this game. Let's go to the phones here. Will is in Tennessee via Skype. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, what's on your mind?
First of all, don't feel bad about the crazy stuff that you have to deal with from these people. I have articles that have been written about us when we first started making a real difference in the way people perceive Muslims, where even though I don't have a passport, I travel to the Middle East on a regular basis. And even though my wife is ethnically Indian and is born and raised in Nairobi, Kenya, she's Iranian.
Okay, so, you've piqued my curiosity. How do you travel to the Middle East on a regular basis with no passport?
Exactly, but that's what's written in articles about me. So it doesn't even have to be true anymore.
Okay. So you're saying they're lying about that? Because I was going to say, I want to know. Let me know how you do that, because that sounds awesome.
Yeah, I'd love to figure it out too. That's what I was saying. It's like, man, boy, I wish I knew how to travel back and forth without a passport. That's really something.
Oh, I know, because you're one of those Muslims, and Muslims don't need passports. And neither do, quote unquote, illegals. You just need to go and tell the people, I'm okay. And then they let you get on the airplane.
So you are Will from the Muslims for Liberty. What were you calling about tonight?
Well, I was actually calling about some, you know, you guys are always have a keen eye for media deception and media bias. And I was noticing that, you know, the latest fantastical, sensational story is about a workplace violence that happened today.
The beheading.
Yes. A guy was fired from his job yesterday and returned to his job today and murdered two of his coworkers.
Have not heard about this.
It's the top story at Drudge Report right now.
I feel very ignorant and as though I'm not doing my job as a journalist.
Well, this isn't a journalism show anyway, but you are a journalist because you do a newscast. But okay, so what are they misrepresenting? What's your interpretation here, Will?
Well, funny enough, another story that wasn't the top story on Drudge Report this week was a man in Alabama.
My hometown, actually.
On Tuesday of this week, was fired from his job Monday, went home, came back to work the next day, and murdered two of his coworkers.
According to the news reports that I had read, he was fired earlier in the month, and he had done some kind of appeal to get the job back, and that was rejected on Monday.
Okay, so these are two different stories about someone killing two coworkers?
Yes. Right.
One in Birmingham, Alabama, a UPS worker.
And the other in Oklahoma.
Yes. Okay. But only one of them is top shelf national news.
Because of a beheading, right?
Well, that's to be, you know.
Or is it something to do with religion or political viewpoint? Why were these people murdered?
That's why I see. Well, that's just it. They haven't really given a reason. They've said that the guy who committed the murders today talked to his coworkers about Islam. But that's all they say in the article. They don't say it's a motivation for anything. They just kind of drop that little bitty piece of information into the middle of the article, though it has no relation to anything and is never tied to anything else in the story. So that kind of gives the impression that we have, you know, a story about one guy that kills two of his coworkers isn't national news because he's a white guy who, you know, it says in the article, his pastor thinks that it was because he was in financial distress.
You know what I would like, Will, is for you to call in tomorrow. I think this would be a good top of the show for our Saturday night show so we can get into more detail on this because a lot of people don't understand Islam and they think that, you know, somebody who beheads, that just because one person commits a beheading that everybody of the religion believes in that. And I know that's not true, but we don't have time to talk about it now. Muslims, the number 4liberty.com is the website.
Org.
Thanks, man. See you tomorrow.
Thank you.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
The latest episode of The Corey Moore Show is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, September 26th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.55 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,220 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $402. Antiwar.com reports the Fatah-Hamas negotiation in Cairo has reached an agreement which will see their national unity government, agreed to back in May, take over control of the Gaza Strip. That ends the long-standing dispute over who would pay government employees in the Strip who had previously been paid by the Hamas government. Officials say they will now be paid by the unity government and will answer to them. In theory, the agreement is effective immediately, though in practice, implementation may take some time. The main goal of the deal is to get border crossings opened for reconstruction material. The unity government, being in control, will also put considerable pressure on Israel to allow that construction material to be sent in faster, without the excuse of acrimony towards Hamas. Israel has opposed the unity government, saying they don't want to deal with any faction which Hamas is even peripherally a part of. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports Eric Holder said on Thursday he would step down as U.S. Attorney General, setting up a potentially bruising Senate fight to confirm a successor who can tackle a long list of pending challenges at the Justice Department. Holder will remain in office until a successor is nominated and confirmed. His nearly six-year term made him one of the nation's longest-serving attorneys general. The next attorney general will face many challenges, including managing counterterror initiatives aimed at Islamic State militants, balancing privacy rights against government surveillance efforts, and deciding whether to continue attempts to prosecute former spy agency contractor Edward Snowden, now living in Russia, for revealing surveillance secrets. Holder's successor will also oversee a series of cases against banks and individuals over manipulation of foreign exchange rates. Holder's department could set off a tense confirmation fight with Republicans in a lame duck U.S. Senate session scheduled after the November 4th midterm elections, although the chamber's majority Democrats can invoke rules making it easier to get around Republican efforts to block the confirmation. Republicans hope to gain a Senate majority in the elections, making it likely Obama will send up a nomination before a new Congress convenes in January. Despite a drumbeat of Republican criticism since becoming Attorney General in 2009, Holder is one of the last three original members of Obama's cabinet, along with Education Secretary Arne Duncan and Agriculture Secretary Tom Vilsack. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now